Something's looking better, baby. Just passing through.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to the Cora Rutherglen Best and Fairest Count and Presentation Night. So we've got a bit to get through tonight. Obviously, this is our first function for a while. It's kind of exciting that we're all together. If we can sort of get started fairly soon, that'll make the night flow a bit better. So there are no set table places. You just need to find a place to sit, make your way there, and enjoy the hospitality of each other. So we'll try to get things underway in a couple of minutes' time. If everyone could sort of make their way towards a table now, that'd be great.
gotta feed the streets. My pistol gon' bleed the streets. Ski mask on my face. Sometimes you gotta cheat to stay ahead in this bitch. Drank syrup like it's liquor. Street life, I have you catching up to God quicker. Yeah. Sticker, AK-40 to your lip. Let the chopper bang on you like a blood or a cripper. Flipper, so much bread, I'm a gymnast. Made so much money off of dummies, off of dummies.
Yeah, gang.
I'm Mr. Body Catcher, Slaughter Gang Soul Snatcher. Ain't no regular F-150, this a fucking Raptor. Yeah. No capper, street nigga, not a rapper. Chopper hit him and he turned into a booty clapper. Smith and Wesson, a 4L gang reppin'. We done baptized more niggas than the damn reverend. Yeah. Kappa Alpha, me and my gang, we do all the steppin'. Who you checkin'? It's FN, shoot East or Westin'.
Young blood thinks there's always tomorrow. I miss your touch on nights when I'm hollow. I know you crossed the bridge that I can't follow. Since the love that you left is all that I get, I want you to know that if I can't be close to you, I'll settle for the ghost of you. I miss you more than life. And if you can't be next to me.
Welcome everybody. We're just about to get underway, so if I can get everyone to make their way to a table, that will make life a lot easier for everyone. Come up to that one, yeah. Okay, so it's been a bit of a long year as far as getting together as footballers, netballers, and community. Tonight's our first opportunity right throughout the whole 2021 season. It's so good that we have been able to get back up here. We're looking forward to having a really good night, full of fun, entertainment, and just a great chance to catch up with each other. A couple of things before we get started. If anyone feels inclined to smoke, which I know we wouldn't have too many of those in a healthy club like this, the balcony area is for the smokers out there. You don't have to go downstairs. I think the toilets are out here through the glass doors, and we just have to make our under 18s aware that there is no serving of alcohol to the under 18s. The other thing is one of our major sponsors, which is Hetherington Plumbing, have put together a little questionnaire, and there should be one on the table there, or you would have got one on the way in. If we can fill out that quick questionnaire, we'll do a draw later in the night, and there is a cash prize of maybe $400.
$150.
Okay, $150. $400's the Ripperoo prize. But so fill those out, get them back to the table during the breaks, and we'll draw $150 out for someone. So we have got a little bit to go through tonight. We want it to flow as smoothly as possible. There will be some breaks, so you can get up and talk to each other. But as soon as we ask you to sit down, we hope that everyone will sit down and we'll be able to flow back into the entertainment. So first of all tonight, I'd like to welcome our president, our illustrious president, Stuart Lingham, who's going to welcome you all here and talk a little bit about the season that we've had and what it's meant to him and our club. Stuart.
Thanks, Craig. First of all, welcome everybody to tonight's presentation night. It's been quite a couple of years since we've got together as a club, so it's very special to be here in magnificent surroundings with everybody dressed up and ready for a good night. So have a great night there. I want to first of all, start off with a couple of thank yous. First of all, to the people who put all the work into setting it up, organising trophies, etc. three people in particular, Graeme Hosier, Rowena Black, and Ron Robinson had major parts. So we'll put our hands together for those three people. To the RSL for providing the venue tonight. This year we've had quite a few on-again, off-again events, and the RSL have been particularly accommodating for us. They've been flexible and they've provided this venue for us for tonight. So to the RSL, thanks very much. They are a major sponsor of ours. We want to support them. We hope we'll have many more functions here over the years. So thank you to the RSL with a round of applause. This year's been a particularly challenging year for everyone, and I guess particularly for our netballers who were setting themselves up for a big final series, but it didn't come to fruition. So while we had some disappointments, we've also got lots of things to celebrate, and that's the focus of tonight, is to acknowledge those who have performed well, the award winners and the trophy winners. So we'll keep it as positive as we possibly can. Congratulations to all the winners tonight. Thoroughly deserved, being a great part of the club and doing your best in every endeavour. So we'll, without any further ado, because there's a lot of other people who are going to speak tonight, we'll get the show on the road. So I'll hand back to Craig and start proceedings. Thanks, Craig.
Thanks, Stuart. Do you want to just...
Okay, so I'll just give you a quick rundown of how the night's going to work. We're going to start off with our vote counts for our under-17 netballers, followed by our under-18 footballers. Our entree will then make its way out. We'll make sure everyone's got something to eat before we move on to the C-grade and B-grade vote count, followed by our reserves vote count. We'll have a break then for dinner, so it'll be a reasonable break and... then we will move into our A-grade netball count, followed by our senior football count. Now, the counts are a combination of a PowerPoint display rolling through, and then the coaches will talk through the final rounds and congratulate the winner on their success. The bar will close during dinner just so we can get through proceedings all right. Once that happens, we'll move through a series of presentations led by Georgie and Olivia for the netballers. Tommy will follow up for the football under 18 awards, and then we'll move on to Sophie and Georgie in the B grade netball, and Daniel will present the reserves football awards. We may have another small break then before we have a quick Zoom crossover to a couple of our Melbourne players. Our trainers are gonna give some awards away. Of course, we have our great Volunteer of the Year award, the Mick Houlihan award, and then our final awards for the A-grade netballers and our Jim Sandrell medal for our best and fairest in the football. So I will call Olivia Sinclair up here now and we'll roll straight into our under-17s vote count. Our media men up the back there will hopefully be ready to go.
Should I say like round one?
I didn't think that was the plan. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, go on.
Round one against Wodonga Bulldogs.
One vote.
Oh, one vote, Riley Shanahan.
Oh, that's going to roll.
No. Oh, okay. I'm just not going to say anything.
I thought there should be some music going on as well.
Round two versus Albury Tigers. Okay, sweet. Cool. Round four, Wangaratta Magpies. Round five, Lavington Panthers. Talika Dickens was best on. And the leaderboard after round five is Talika Dickens on 9 votes, Riley Shanahan 9 votes, Sophie Kennedy 10 votes with Shelby Richardson, Grace Kennedy 18 votes, and Steph Sutcliffe on 21 votes. Round six versus Yarrawonga. Best on was Steph Sutcliffe. Round seven against Wodonga Raiders. Best on was Sophie Kennedy. Round eight against Wangaratta Rovers. Best on was Grace Kennedy. Round nine against Wodonga Bulldogs. Best on was Grace Kennedy and Gemma Smith. Round 10 against Myrtleford. Best on with Steph Sutcliffe and Talika Dickens. And the leaderboard after round 10 is Izzy Bush and Chelsea Parker on 4 votes, Maka Van Maslem on 6 votes, Gemma Smith 14 votes, Talika Dickens 16, Sophie Kennedy on 19 votes, Riley Shanahan and Shelby Richardson on 21, Steph on 36 votes, and Grace Kennedy on 39 votes. Round 11 versus North Albury. 1 vote Chelsea Parker, 2 votes Grace Kennedy, 3 votes Gemma Smith, 1 vote Gemma Smith, 2 votes Riley Shanahan, 3 votes Talika Dickens, 1 vote Steph Sutcliffe, 2 votes Chelsea Parker, 3 votes Riley Shanahan. Round 12 against Wangaratta Magpies. 1 vote Grace Kennedy, 2 votes Steph Sutcliffe, 3 votes Gemma Smith, 1 vote Gemma Smith, 2 votes Shelby Richardson, 3 votes Grace Kennedy, 1 vote Riley Shanahan, 2 votes Steph Sutcliffe, 3 votes Grace Kennedy. Our last round, round 13 against Wayne Rovers, 1 vote Chelsea Parker, 2 votes Sophie Kennedy, 3 votes Grace Kennedy, 1 vote Steph Sutcliffe, 2 votes Riley Shanahan, 3 votes Grace Kennedy, 1 vote Isabel Bush, 2 votes Chelsea Parker, 3 votes Grace Kennedy. And the seven under 17's best and fairest runner up is Stephanie Sutcliffe. And the best and fairest for the under 17s this year was Grace Kennedy.
Fantastic effort there, Grace. Well done. I'm sure your teammates and all the supporters will be around you while we're enjoying this great night and congratulating everyone. I know Georgie spoke a little bit during the year at one of our training runs about the Kennedy girls and what they do to get here to play netball. And I'm sure we'll touch on that a little bit in our speech for the greater Ruse netball and football community. Okay, we're going to roll straight into our under-18 vote count now. I know Tommy's making his way up here to this stage. So without any further ado, I'll introduce Tommy Renshaw, the coach of our under-18 footballers. He might just say a quick word before he rolls into the count.
I don't actually have a lot to say. It's actually a little bit weird being out, to be honest, living in Victoria. So, yeah, it's good to be around some people for once. Yep. All right, round one versus Wodonga Bulldogs. We went down by a few goals today. I've been told not to read the votes yet until the last three games. Aubrey, we got a fair touch up here. It's a bit of a long day. North Aubrey, Rizza kicked 7 in the first quarter. Ended up with 9 for the game, I think. 9-7, I think he finished up with. Finn Osborne racked up about 40 touches this game, I reckon. Probably one of the best games I've seen from a 16-year-old. We knocked over Lavi this day at home. It was all... Everyone played well this game. Leaderboards after round 5. Third is Jacob Haberman with Finn Osborne, Ryan Beveridge and Jesse Johnston. Round 6, Sierra Wonga. Should have won this game. The boys had a pretty solid session the night before. Jesse played well again. Raiders, I think we went down by about 3 or 4 goals. That pretty much summed up our year, really. Going down by 3 or 4 goals most weeks. Rovers, I can't even really remember where we played them, to be honest. The draw got changed that much. Bulldogs up there. Rizza got a heap of attention going through these rounds now. H turned it on going to a wing. Murdiford, freezing cold. I ended up in surgery, so I missed this one, kind of, thank God. So leaderboard after round 10. So third, we've got Finn Osborne on 28, Ryan Beveridge on 37, coming second, and Jesse Johnston on 41 with 3 games to go. Yeah. Round 11 versus North Aubrey. Vote Caleb Black, 1 vote Matty Hintz, 1 vote Ollie Struve, 2 votes Rizza, 3 votes. Jesse Johnston, 1 vote. Matty Hintz, 1 vote. Matty Holton, 1 vote. Rizza, 2 votes. Jesse Johnston, 3 votes. Ollie Struve, 1 vote. Matty Holton, 1 vote. Jackson Lewis, 1 vote. Jesse Johnston, 2 votes. Ryan Beveridge, 3 votes. Dogger. Round 12 versus Wang Magpies. 1 vote, Holly Struve. 1 vote, Finn Osborne. 1 vote, Jesse Johnston. 2 votes, Ethan Hanrahan, 3 votes. Matthew Bush, 1 vote. Finn Osborne, 1 vote. Jesse Johnston, 1 vote. Ollie Struve, 2 votes. Matty Bush, 3 votes. Ethan Hanrahan, 1 vote. Finn Osborne, 1 vote. Ollie Struve, 1 vote. Benny Black, 2 votes. Matty Bush, 3 votes. Ethan Hanrahan. Round 13 versus Rovers. 1 vote, Ryan Beveridge. 1 vote, Jackson Lewis. 1 vote, Marcus Reed. 2 votes, Jesse Johnston. 3 votes, Matty Holton. 1 vote, Ryan Beveridge. 1 vote, Matty Holton. 1 vote, Aaron Spencer. 2 votes, Jesse Johnston. 3 votes, Finn Osborne. 1 vote, Finn Osborne. 1 vote, Matty Bush. 1 vote, Jackson Lewis. 2 votes, Ethan Hanrahan. 3 votes, Jesse Johnston. So the 2021 Best and Fairest for the under 18s. Runner up this year. Leading goal kicker for the comp, Ryan Beveridge. Pretty outstanding considering he's an underage kid, and to win the comp in the under 18s, and he's still got another year to go. It only goes to show what he's going to do next year. And the best and fairest winner, it's pretty amazing, Jesse Johnston. It's a bit of an omen because I actually have nothing to do with the awards or the votes at all, and it's kind of a bit of a blessing because I'm actually related to him. And I copped a fair bit of stick off Wagunya at the start of the year. I got phone calls about poaching their players, but it just goes to show that the kid's got a lot of talent and he can play under 18s again next year. So congratulations to Jesse.
Thanks, Tom. Very exciting count there and an exciting win there for Jesse. So well done. Hopefully everyone's got their entree by now and enjoying some nice food. We'll continue to roll through our best and fairest counts. We'll move on to our C-grade netballers. I'm just trying to spot Sophie in the crowd to see if she's finished her entree. Okay, Sophie, it was an exciting year for the C-graders. Are you expecting a close count?
Yes.
All right. You stay up here and commentate at Peru.
Okay. Oh.
Oh. This is just a running sheet.
Oh, okay.
If you just sort of try and say, round one, we played against Dogs, we had a great game.
Oh, cool.
Anything you can think of along the way.
Yeah.
Just have to speak close to the microphone.
Okay, cool. Round one against Wodonga, the girls had a pretty good win. 7 votes to our newest recruit, Georgia Clark. Round two against Aubrey, I think we went down that game. And 8 votes to Kush. Round three against North Aubrey. We had another loss. We had Steph Sutcliffe and Riley Shanahan step up from the under 17s. So good job, girls. Round four against Wang Maggie's, we had a win. Emma Sinclair, 4 votes. Round five against Lavi, we went down this game. Jade Lane, 7 votes. The noodle. Oh, sorry. So the leaderboard after round five, Lily Hanrahan, 5th, Jade Lane on 9 votes, Georgia Clark 3rd on 12, Jess King 13, and Beck Cushett on 26 votes. Round six against Yarra. Yes! And Lily Hanrahan with 8 votes. We went down that game. Round 7 against Raiders. Again, we had Steph Sutcliffe from the 17 step up and Lily Hanrahan with 9 votes. Round 8 against Rovers. Molly King, Lily Hanrahan, Kush and Jade Lane with 9 and Sinkers with 1. Round 9 against Bulldogs. Georgia Kate and Georgie. Jess King, 9 votes. Round 10 against Myrtleford, we have Emma O'Keefe's first game with 1 vote and Georgie O'Brien with 5. So the leaderboard after round 10, Steph and Riley there with 6 votes, Molly King 8 on 9 votes, Emma and Georgia Clark on 6, Georgie O'Brien 5th, Jade 4th, Jess 2nd, Lily also 2nd and Kush. Round 11 against North Albury, 1 vote, Jade Lane, 2 votes, Georgia Clark, 3 votes, Beck Cushett, 1 vote, Jade Lane, 2 votes, Georgia Clark, 3 votes, Lily Hanrahan, 1 vote, Georgie O'Brien, 2 votes, Georgia Clark, 3 votes, Beck Cushett. Round 12 against Maggie's, 1 vote, Jade Lane, 2 votes, Georgia Clark. 3 votes, Lily Hanrahan. 1 vote, Georgia Clark. 2 votes, Jade Lane. 3 votes, Emma O'Keefe. 1 vote, Beck Cushett. 2 votes, Molly King. 3 votes, Lily Hanrahan. Round 13 against Rovers. 1 vote, Lily Hanrahan. 2 votes, Beck Cushett. 3 votes, Georgie O'Brien. 1 vote, Beck Cushett. 2 votes, Jess King. 3 votes, Emma O'Keefe. 1 vote, Lily Hanrahan. 2 votes, Emma Sinclair. 3 votes, Beck Cushett. The suspense. So the C-grade best and fairest runner-up is Lily Hanrahan. Good job, Lil. And your C-grade best and fairest for 2021 is Beck Cushett.
Thanks, Sophie. That's a fantastic result. I think Beck's a multiple best and fairest winner for the club. She's won it at the league level before, so it's exciting what might happen at the league count in a few weeks. Terrific servant of our club, and congratulations, Beck. It's a fantastic win. Okay, we'll roll straight from the C grade into our B grade. We'll call up our illustrious B grade coach, Georgie Bruce. Obviously, our B grade has finished on top of the ladder this year in what has been a golden era for the Coorowhatta Glen netballers. I'm sure Georgie's expecting a close count, and I'm sure she'll talk us through and make it as exciting as possible, Georgie.
Nah, I'll let you enjoy your food and we'll just scroll through. But I reckon it's going to be a nail biter. B graders, pay attention. Was a cute picture. So we've got a few on the board. Zali Spencer was definitely a given. A little bit of story there. She was meant to start in the goals and unfortunate for her, she played defence all year. Look at that wingspan, Zali. No wonder you couldn't see past it. Lily's back in there. We picked up Lily from Yarrawonga. She's been a fantastic inclusion. Lucy McGuinness, another girl that we've managed to pick up this year. Maddie O'Keefe from Wangaratta playing for us in the blue and white. Lavi Panthers, but it's a photo of magpies. Well done, Zoe. So after round five, the leaderboard, Keezy on 12 and Lily in fourth position, Zoe 14, Maddie O'Keefe 15 and Zali Spencer out in front on 21. I think it said 21, it's either 21 or 27. Round six against the Pigeons, we definitely took their flight that day. Lily smashed her other team. Zoe McLeish is back in form, best on ground that day. Maddie O'Keefe stars again back in Wangaratta. Round nine against the Bulldogs. Must have been a fairly good team game. There's votes there from one end of the court to the other. Myrtleford, that was a tough day out. We were short a couple of players that day, but good to see the votes got shared around with Zoe starring. That was her in goalkeeper. She loved it. After round 10, the leaderboard is, let's just go up. We'll go from sixth, so 21 with Keezy, Maddie O'Keefe on 27, Zoe and Zali. Lisa Tobin has snuck in there to be second on 29 and Lily Sharp 34. So round 11 versus North Albury. One vote, Zali Spencer. Two votes, Lily Sharp. Three votes, Lisa Tobin. One vote, Keezy Corkett. Two votes, Zali Spencer. Three votes, Lily Sharp. One vote, Zali Spencer. Two votes, Jimmy Taylor. Three votes, Lily Sharp. Round 12 versus Wangaratta Magpies. One vote, Lily Sharp. Two votes, Zoe McLeish. Three votes, Zali Spencer. Told you you'd get that girl, Zali. One vote, Maddie O'Keefe. Two votes, Keezy Corkett. Three votes, Zali Spencer. One vote, Maddie O'Keefe. Two votes, Zali Spencer. And three votes, Jimmy Taylor. Round 13, final game against Wang Rovers. One vote, Lucy McGuinness. Two votes, Zali Spencer. Three votes, Jimmy Taylor. One vote, Lisa Tobin. Two votes, Zoe McLeish. Three votes, Zali Spencer. One vote, Lily Sharp. Two votes, Lisa Tobin. And three votes, Zali Spencer. I'll wait for it to come up on the screen. I know the answers, but I'll wait. So our 2021 Best and Fairest runner-up is Lily Sharp. And our B-grade Best and Fairest winner for 2021 is Zali Spencer.
Well done, Zali. I may be a bit biased, but you've obviously had a very good year. Congratulations on that. I know you're good friends with Lily Sharp, and she was right behind you in the count, so it's a bit of a quinella there for a couple of really good friends. Thanks, Georgie, for talking us through that. We're just going to clear the tables now. We'll have a little break so that you can grab a drink, go to the toilet, and then we'll come back very shortly, and Georgie will wind us up for the A-grade count as well. So we'll be back in 10 minutes. Oh, hang on. Sorry, I've missed one. Sorry, take a seat. Sorry, I just teed Daniel up to come up here and then forgot about him again. So Daniel Athanitis is going to make his way to the stage right now. Daniel, we'll do the reserves count before we go to that little break. So Daniel's had he's had one of the toughest jobs in the Ovens and Murray Football League this year, but he's done it fantastically well, and I'm sure he's got a few things to say about the way the boys fought out the season. Daniel.
Thanks, Craig. Yeah, firstly, I'd like to thank the footy club giving me the opportunity to do what I did this year. Although people kept saying it was the hardest job in football and things like that, I actually did enjoy it with the group that we had, probably through sporting connections that we already had, sort of helped a little bit. Yeah, we did do it tough, but at the end of the day, we got through it. We got through it together. We had a couple. We had one good win. Should have had a couple, but you know, we got through the season. So yeah, really proud of the boys, and yeah, wrapped with what we did. So we'll go through the award votes. I don't say anything. Yeah. First game against Wodonga. Well, fair to say a few boys are a little bit underdone. There's Rosie. She's a long day at the office, this one. This was probably one game we should have won, but we probably let slip a little bit. Bacco. Rosie, come on board that day, that was good. That was a long night. Robbo starting to pull well, the Pern, the Nagger, starting to come good. This today, I think we had about 12 players. Labby helped us out, so that was really good. Nat, yep, the Nag, yep. Leader. Bowie Shill, Whiskey Man, Sticks. Nagger with that ball drop, looking good, mate. Yarra, another long day. Yeah, wasn't great. The Cushman. Raiders had a pretty good game that day. Another one that we let slip. Rosie. This was the win. This was it. This was the big day. Geordie Lavis was good. And the Pern. Nagger starting to really come home now. Bulldogs are Bulldogs. This was when we were graced with Matt Wilson's presence. He'd be disappointed with one vote. And Blakey, yeah, he played, had a good game. Mert at Mert. We didn't have enough for a cricket team, but we got there. We got it done. Oh, Bacco. Where's, Oh, it's too loud, I think. Round 10. Oh, this is the leaderboard. Sticks, Will Seymour, Bailey Pernag just starting to really make a move, which is good. I think he made it. He had a few senior games, though. That was probably might hurt him in the long run, but. So North Albury at North. One vote. Bowie Shield. Bacco, Sticks, Perna, oh, Willie Seymour, starting to come home, I think, Will. Oh. That's five, Nag. Spencer had a good game. Versus Wang at home. Drucey, the ego, beautiful day he was. It was a great day. Mattress, I didn't know you played that day. Did you have a spell? Lukey Backhouse, Stixie, Preston had a good game, Hearn, Macca, oh, Mattress! Well done, Mattress. Against the Rovers, last game. Jeddah! So where's Jed? Two votes, Bailey Minogue. Willie Seymour, gonna be tied, I think. Alex Finlayson, you a beauty. Bailey Minogue, three votes. Lockie Corp, I don't know how, yeah, okay. Yeah, Ty Carl, Lukey Cushett, Willie Seymour. Very, gonna be close, I think. So the winners. Runner-up, Seymour Butts. Well done, Seymour. Well deserved. And the winner, the Nagger. Well done, Bailey. Very well deserved, mate.
Thanks, Daniel. Well done. Bailey, he was in the shop today and he talked about bringing a wheelbarrow along to bring all these trophies home, so he must have known that he was going to be on the money. It was great to see two young fellas like that fighting out for first and second and all the other contributors, because whilst it was a tough year for the team, these guys really shone out, and it's great to see the future of our club coming through the way that it is. There's the final leaderboard so everyone can see how many votes they got. Obviously, we spread our vote count around nicely over all the players that played through the team, and a great outcome altogether. Okay, we'll now move into that break that I spoke about a bit earlier. The tables will be cleared. Grab yourself a drink. Go to the toilet, and we'll be back in 10 minutes, and Georgie will take us through the B grade. A grade. Sorry, Zali.
Your loving hand out, baby. I'm begging. I'm begging, begging you to put your loving hand out, baby. I'm begging, begging you to put your loving hand out, darling. Riding high when I was king, I played it hard and fast, but I had everything. I walked away, you want me then, but easy come and easy go, and it would end. So anytime I bleed, you let me go, yeah. Anytime I feel, you got me, no. Anytime I see, you let me know, but the plan and see, just let me go. I'm on my knees when I'm begging, I don't wanna lose you. Hey, yeah. Ra-da-da-da. Cause I'm begging, begging you. Put your loving hand out, baby. I'm begging, begging you. Put your loving hand out, darling. I need you to understand. Try so hard to be a man. The kind of man you want in the end. Only then can I
Why the bottom? Why the basement? Why we got good? She don't embrace it. Why the feel for the need to replace me? You're the wrong way, trying to the good. I went up in a feature town where we could be at. Like a heart in the best way, shit. You can't give it away, you have, and you took the bait. But I keep walking on, keep moving the dust, keep open for. That the dog is yours, keep also home. Cause I'm the one that left in a broken home, girl, I'm begging. Yeah, I'm begging, begging you to put your love in the air now, baby. I'm begging, begging you to put your love in the hand now, darling. I'm finding hard to hold my own, just can't make it all alone. I'm holding on, I can't fall back. I'm just a call, but your face is like.
Okay, we'll try and keep the night rolling on. Like I said, we're going to have some breaks, but we need them to be quick breaks. And if everyone can make their way back to the table now, we'll move into our next count so that we've got plenty of time to present trophies later on. And to all those people who are watching the live stream from their homes, those who didn't quite get through the vaccination stage or just couldn't be here because you're in Melbourne, we thank you for tuning in, and hopefully you have a really enjoyable night watching everyone here get together and have some great times again. Okay, Georgie, I'm going to ask you to make your way up here to the stage so that you can roll out the count for our sensational A-grade netballers who have just come through their third sensational season, finished on top of the ladder, and they are just an absolute treasure to our club. Let's see how they go in the count.
Thanks, Craig. Yeah, look, while we're just getting that up and running, it has been disappointing for these girls. I know that they've certainly worked really hard to stay together as a group and build on their connectiveness and so on, and COVID sort of got in the way of them having their success. But I think that from Corowa's point of view, we've definitely put ourselves out there in the ovens of Murray now as a force to be reckoned with across all grades of netball, so we can't be disappointed in that.
Someday I would just fly, fly away, and I always knew.
So round one was against the very rough Wodonga Bulldogs. No surprises there, that Grace is on top, and Sophie got some votes. It's her favourite club, Wodonga. Round two, Aubrey Tigers. They always push us. Sophie Hanrahan with 7 votes. Good to see a nice spread of votes being delegated to a sensational team, though. Few twos. And Jess Spice with 5 against North Aubrey. That's a drink there, Jess. Round four against Wang Maggies, which was a grand final rematch. Sophie Hanrahan came away with 6. Round five versus Lavington Panthers. They were an uncertainty this year, but nothing much fazed us there. Sophie Hanrahan with 7, Jen Barrett with 6. The A-grade leaderboard after round five, 5th place, Alla on 9, third, Jen and Jess on 11, 2nd, Grace on 15, and Sophie Hanrahan on 27. Round 6, this was a pearler game against Pigeons, even if I do say so myself. 16 goal win, Sophie Hanrahan with 6, Gracie with 5. Round 7, Wodonga Raiders. Ella Kingston with 5 votes. Laz is on the board with 4. Round 8 versus Wang Rovers. That was at our home ground. Sophie Hanrahan must have carved it up that day with 8 votes. Round 9, Wodonga Bulldogs. Let's see if Sophie Hanrahan polls anything. Still got 3. Sophie, you had a lot to say that game, for those of you that are playing along at home. Round 10, Myrtleford. They were a great side this year. Ella Kingston with 5. Zali Spencer was a goal attack in that game with 1. That was the Jess Bice's Hens party weekend. Round 10, the leaderboard, 10th Zoe McLeish with 2, Zali Spencer 2, Brooke 8. We'll just go up to 4th. We'll go Ella Kingston 21, M. Larissy 24, Grace Senior 31, and Sophie with half a century. Round 11 versus North Aubrey. 1 vote, Liv Sinclair. 2 votes, Sophie Hanrahan. 3 votes, Brooke Bice. 1 vote, Brooke Bice. 2 votes, Liv Sinclair. 3 votes, Sophie Hanrahan. 1 vote, Sophie Hanrahan. 2 votes, M. Lara. 3 votes, Grace Senior. Round 12 versus Wangaratta Magpies. We lost. This is the one game we lost for the season by 1 goal. 1 vote, M. Larissy. 2 votes, Brooke Bice. 3 votes, Liv Sinclair. 1 vote, Grace Senior. 2 votes, M. Lara. 3 votes, Brooke Bice. 1 vote, M. Lara. 2 votes, Liv Sinclair. And 3 votes, Gracie Senior. Big shout out to those girls that couldn't be here today. Due to COVID, 1 vote, Sophie Hanrahan. 2 votes, Jen Barrett. 3 votes, Jess Bice. 1 vote, Brooke Bice. 2 votes, Sophie Hanrahan. 3 votes, Jess Bice. Jess had a pearl of this game. 1 vote, Brooke Bice. 2 votes, Jen Barrett. 3 votes, Sophie Hanrahan. The suspense is killing us. Who will win? So the 2021 A-grade Best and Fairest runner-up is Gracie Senior. Gracie unfortunately can't be here tonight, but and she would be spewing that she's not here to be able to receive this, but good on you, Gracie. And the A-grade Best and Fairest winner is So Fresh. Well done, So.
Thanks, Georgie. A great count for a great team. Gracie Senior, well done on coming runner-up, but obviously Sophie Hanrahan, she's an outright champion. She's won this award before. She's won it at the league before, and maybe we'll get a trifecta Sophie at the league count coming up in a few weeks' time. Congratulations. We're all really proud of all our netballers, the way that they finished the season. And it's a real pity that we didn't get that premiership flag, but we got the club champion or whatever it was called for finishing on top. So, Peter German, if you can make your way up here now, we will roll through the vote count for our senior footballers and see who is going to be our Jim Sandrell medalist. And we'll get Daniel Athanitis up here to assist Peter. So Daniel, you might make your way up here and help Germo out.
We can only use one while the count's going on, apparently. We can use two later on.
Oh, okay, but the virtual we're going to use it. Yeah. He's going to use it now. So
you might just have to stand close. You're going to have to stand up here, buddy.
Yep. No, that's all right. You can sit down.
Oh, there you go. Back the other way now.
So this is the same. Yeah. This is it. Dance is not easy. Sit up here, Pumper. Thanks, Craig, for that. I guess from my point of view, it's my first season at the club. And I guess there's been, when I say challenges, there's always challenges when you coach any sort of sporting organisation. But I was really excited to be able to come up, certainly start to create, I guess, friendships and build a bond with the playing group. So I felt that at the start of the year we got a good core group of guys who committed to their pre-season, and hopefully they're going to commit to the pre-season even greater next year. But so I guess we're always under pressure a bit with COVID. We were never sure when and where. We had a couple of long breaks. Ladies, thank you. Sorry, I can't hear myself speak. To be able to push through and get 13 games out and I guess from a football point of view put ourselves into a position where we actually started to get some real growth was exciting, and I guess that's going to be about us going forward as well. But I was really pleased to see the way everyone approached the season, certainly the netballers. I really enjoyed watching, you know, the times we could actually get and watch the C's and the B's play. We couldn't get to see the A-grade play. I was really looking forward to seeing the girls do their thing in the final series, but unfortunately that didn't happen. But again, that's what I'm hoping as a club and as an organisation, we're going to stick together and continue to keep the club moving forward in a real positive way, and I'm looking forward to the netballers and the footballers continuing that closeness that we built over pre-season, and we can do it again in 2002. So what actually happens with the best and fairest, I've never been big on locking in, so where it's a 3-2-1 or a 1-2-3-4-5 or whatever. I've tried to do it where we actually, and you'll see here on our, it's a voting system, so it's basically a ranking system. So every player gets ranked between 0 and 5. So 5's a perfect game, basically. 4's an outstanding game. 3, you've had a high impact. 2, you've played your role really well. 1, you've made a contribution. And 0, you've either been injured or you haven't really had the best of games. So what happens is I do one vote, and Pumper and Dave Melksham do another combined one together, and we add those two together. So there's 2 vote cards that get added together. So you'll find that when we've had a really good win or we've played well, most players will get a vote. And when we haven't played that well, which we did, I guess, in a couple of games, there's probably minimal votes. But anyway, we'll go through it. And I've got Pumper here to throw a bit of light relief, bit of comedy. Get up here, mate. So it's a bit of a Brownlow type thing where Benny Black has put together a bit of a compilation of
the first
edits.
Game of the year, Cora Rutherglen took on the Wodonga Bulldogs in a packed-out John Paul Oval on Easter Saturday. The game was expected to be closer than many expected. With 7 debutants, Cora looked right at home when Hayden Filippone starred with a game high with 20 disposals and 3 goals, as well as Jared Lane with 17 touches and 3 goals. Cora finished on top, winning by 19 points, with the score being 17-8-112 to Wodonga Bulldogs 14-7-91. After a good win against the Wodonga Bulldogs, the Roos had to travel to the Albury Sports Ground to play the Albury Tigers. After a sluggish start, the Roos were not able to create a spark that was required to beat the Tigers. But Cameron Wilson and Jared Lane played a massive game, racking up 24 and 26 touches between them. The Roos were not able to get the job done, going down 20-17-137 to Corowa 6-16-52.
By Darcy Melton, being one of Cora's best. Here is Cora's best. Jared Lane, sweeping kick into half forward. Bradkey, Ellis, ball my co. He's Bradkey, forced in for it, and does. And the young fella runs in and slams through a goal for the Roos.
I think distance might be the only issue, but I'll back him in.
Come on, Abe. Bradkey, do you want to back him in, or do you want to sit on the fence?
It's hard to say. You said not to trust everything Monty said.
Yeah.
So.
Yep. And he looks like he might have kicked it.
He has kicked it! That's a Sunjan goal that they contend.
Round 3, Cora returned to the John Ford Oval to play North Albury, with Mac Lavis making his senior debut. The Roos looked promising all game, dominating the inside 50s 62-34. The Roos were helped by Caelan Bradkey with a season high of 3 goals, and Cameron Wilson being consistent, racking up 30 touches with 24 kicks and 6 handballs. The Roos were too strong in the end, winning 13-22-100 to North Albury 7-5-47.
yeah. Get a feeling that I never, 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 never had before. No, 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 I get a good feeling, yeah. Oh, sometimes I get a good feeling, yeah.
Righto, so round one, votes. And our first win was was fantastic. I think the best part of the day was obviously winning and then coming in the club rooms after the game. So obviously our PowerPoint's not working, so it's going straight up there. We had a fair few debuts that day. But in terms of the votes, I won't read them all out. You can see them up there, but Hayden Filippone had a fantastic game. Tommy Goodwin, Jared Lane, both polled well. With Shug Hansen, Gus and Damian Wilson also having great games. So round one, it was great to get off to a winning start to the season. Round two. Righto, let's see if we can go now. Go. Okay, played Aubrey up there. Had a fantastic first quarter. We had, I think, six more inside 50s than Aubrey. But kicked one goal, 7-2 out in the full, so that probably didn't help us start on a great note. But Matty Klempke played his first game. Charlie Anastasio, I know Charlie's watching. He just sent a photo before, and we'll probably have a quick chat with Charlie and the boys. And Doc with one vote. Hayden Filippone, Matty Grantham, two. Young Darcy. Hello to Darcy, too, sitting at home with his dad. I'm not sure why his dad's not allowed here tonight, but anyway. Ask Kiwi. If anyone's not sure, ask Kiwi. Jared Lane, four. Cam Wilson, four. And the big fella, Tommy Goodwin, he just terrorised young Benny Kelly that day in the ruck. But unfortunately, I think that just showed us we still needed to do a fair bit of work. Round three. North Aubrey.
Yeah, today, good result for us. I think we nearly kicked 100 points, didn't we, that day? So, yeah, it was all happening in the box at times, which was good. It's nice and intense. I can't even see who won those.
I'll read them out. Doc, Jack Shule, Gusslingham won. Maxi Taylor, two, who can't make it tonight again. I think he wasn't double vaxxed, unfortunately. Mac, who made his debut that day. Played a terrific, done some really good things that day. KB, Matty Wilson, Scoot, Marksy and Cody Howard, two. Hanson, Grantham, Nastasi, Damian Wilson, and Filippone, three. Darcy Melksham, four. Jared Lane, five. Tommy Goodwin, five. And Cam Wilson, six. We'll move on to the next block of rounds.
To play the Wangaratta Magpies on Anzac Day Eve, with Jared Lane racking up 100 senior games for the club. With the contents looming after the first quarter, the Roos had a few lapses of concentration and not being able to capitalise on their errors. But week in, week out, Cameron Wilson shined on the big stage with 31 touches and 22 kicks, who was also helped out by his captain Joe Hanson with 22 touches. Unfortunately, Wangaratta proved too strong, winning 16-15, 111 to Corowa, 5-10-14.
They've been doing around the ground is rewarded. Yes, so Doherty close them straight in front, 25 metres out. Looks good off the boot, and it's a goal. So well done to the Roos end.
Round 5, and son of a gun, Ryan Ayres made his senior debut as Cora Rutherglen took on the reigning premiers, Lavington Panthers. The Roos came into the match as outsiders, but the boys were able to show the potential of what the team could become. They proved their dominance with Kyle Doherty blasting 8 goals and Hayden Filippone with 20 touches and 3 goals, leading the Roos to their first win over Lavington Panthers in 10 years, with the final score being 13-7-83 to Lavington 9-10-64.
Right, it was a big day for the club that day. But anyway, round 5 against Wangaratta, we found out that, again, the two top sides, Aubrey and Wang, were still had plenty of muscle and they were pretty tough to get on top of. But one vote is there, Grantham, Goodwin, Lingham, Marks and Melksham. Two votes, Hanson, Howard, Nastasi and Jack Shilg. Three votes, Jared Lane. Four votes, Damien Wilson. And 5 votes, Cam Wilson. Round 5, I think it was the first time for many players they actually beat Lavington, who obviously were the premiers in the season, the last premiers of whenever that was, 2019. One vote, Maxie Taylor. 2, Ryan Ayres, who played his first senior game. You've seen the photo with his pop and his dad. 3 votes there. 4. Keep going. 5 to Cam, 6 to Cam Wilson and Marksy and the big Doc, who's now at CDHBU. And he went with our blessing, by the way, and he ended up with probably the most max... I think that was the highest votes we had for the year, was 7 votes. So the leaderboard after round 5. So we start from the bottom, just hang on. Anyway, keep going, Ro. So at the moment, Cam Wilson on 24, Jared Lane on 21, Tommy Goodwin on 19... Hayden Filippone, 15. Damien Wilson, 15. With Darcy Melksham, 14. Joey, 13. Charlie Nastasi, Cole Doherty on 12. And rounding out the top 10 is Marksy and Matty Grantham. Round 6. Let's go.
Round 6, Cora Rutherglen travelled to the JC Lowe Oval to play the Yarrawonga Pigeons. Both teams started positively with a tight contest at halftime. The Cora defence were challenged at times but played a strong game. Joe Hanson was a standout with 18 touches, as well as young gun Matt Wilson with 15 touches and 2 pivotal goals near the end. But Yarrawonga came out with the win on top by 6 points, with the score being 10-12-72 to Yarrawonga 11-12-78. But I'm on my way, so hold tight. I'm coming home tonight. Meet me in the valley where the kids collide into the morning. Oh my God, my town is coming alive. I'm coming home tonight. I know you're ready for the... Round 7, and Coro is back at the John Ford Oval to take on the Wodonga Raiders. A game that saw the two teams even for 3/4 of the game. Players such as Matt Grantham and Charlie Nastasi getting 19 touches between them, and the midfield creating plenty of opportunities with 44 inside 50s to the Raiders 35. But Cora fell short, going down 7-9-51 to the Raiders 9-14-68.
Yeah, definitely the distance is the issue for him.
He comes in now and he kicks it from 48 metres. Not a
problem! No issue!
No worries at all!
And Filippone gets the ruse back in front. Wodonga Raiders, as I said, have kicked the last five goals of the game. They lead it by 23 points. The last chance here, Damian Wilson runs inside, forward 50. Wilson from downtown, Sundown goal of the day.
Round 8 was the start of the COVID interruptions to the season. Coming back after 4 weeks off, Corowa took on the Wangaratta Rovers with an understrength side. Big games from Cade Cushett racking up 20 touches and Damien Wilson with 34. But the Roos were not able to convert in front of goals and the Rovers capitalising on the Roos' mistakes, going down 5-9-39 to the Rovers 8-16-64.
Nice demo.
Had much to do with it, but I think he will. And it'll be a point, don't worry about that. Comes in straight through the middle, never doubted him.
Go through the votes, round 6 versus Yarra. Had a really good day. It was just really disappointing in the end. I reckon that was nearly our most disappointing game. Matty Wilson, one vote. Learn how not to do a U-turn. Two votes. Das, Marksy, Logues. Three votes that day. Matty Grantham, Gussie, Jared Lane, Tommy Goodwin. Lefty up there with four. Had another good game. Shilgi, Chucky, Nastasi, Kush. Oh, the captain, five votes, must have had a good one. Cameroon and the Demon, six votes. Round 7. Raiders at home. Yep, it was probably our biggest learning curve. One votes, few one voters in there. Das polling, starting to poll pretty well. Mattress again. Howie, Eggy. Jackie Shield. Had another good one. Cam Wilson and Charlie again. I reckon Damon again. Another big one from Damo. Round 8 versus the Rovers. It was a 3-week patch where we could have won all three. Max Taylor, another good game. It was one of Rosie's first games, I think. It's good to get him back involved. Das again with three. Kush, the young bloke, four votes. Damien making a very late charge, five votes.
Round 9, Corowa travelled to Martin Park to play the Wodonga Bulldogs. The Roos were shaky early in the first half, only managing one goal. But then after a fight back emerged, led by Jared Lane, 28 touches, Damien Wilson, 29 touches, Tom Goodwin, 21 touches, 41 hitouts and a goal, almost led a fight back against the Dogs. But ultimately, the Dogs were too strong, winning 14-8-92 to Corowa 8-8-56. And pack your bags real good, baby, cause you'll be gone for a while. Round 10 saw Cora Rutherglen travel to the McNamara Reserve to take on the 4th place Saints. Mark Athanatis made his senior debut for the Roos. In a wet and muddy contest, the Roos had another slow start, which ultimately cost them. The second half of the game saw the Roos keep the Saints to only one goal, with Cade Cushett playing a solid game in defence. The Roos put in a hard-fought 4th quarter, but lost to Myrtleford by 13 points. With the final score being 5-7-37 to Myrtleford 7-8-50.
Time for the new Athenitis and a bounce of... Oh! A steal on goal today from Mark Athenitis. The late inclusion, that's the spark. That's the spark Cora wanted.
Hotel scoreboard will be there later on this afternoon. Here's a chance for Wilson, top of the goal square. 1-on-1 battle, well done by Matt Dustin. Did he keep it alive? He did it. Nastasi. Kick down the line, the good one. The Roos are out here if they can slow things down. They want to go deep inside. For the Nastasi, who was slowing it up before. Handball go to the top. Find the teammate and throw. Into the open goal. Game on.
Right, round nine, Wodonga Bulldogs, probably our worst game. That was a game where they come and attacked us early and I don't think we really got going until half time. So one vote, Marks, Nastasi, Kate Cushett and Joey Hansen. Two votes, Howard. Three votes, Damien Wilson, Grantham, Lane, Goodwin, Cam Wilson and Rosie. Round 10. Against Myrtleford in the Mub. Low-scoring game, but we really fought back and almost put ourselves in a winning position. One vote, Athenitis, Nastasi, Lingham and Melksham. Two votes to Grantham. Three votes to Rose, Lane, Howard and Jack Shilg. Four votes to Cam Wilson, Damien Wilson and Tommy Goodwin, who I know's at home. He's drinking his light Cascades, I think, Tommy. Make sure. And Cush played an absolute ripper that game, I reckon, held us in the contest for a long, long time. So the round leaderboard after round 10. So there's from 11 to 25. Jackie Shilg just missing out in the top 10 at the moment. So in equal ninth is Melksham and Cushett. In equal fifth, there's a four-way tie in fifth at the moment, which is Filippone, Grantham, Hansen and Nastasi. Third, equal third at the moment is Goodwin and Lane. We second Damien Wilson on 39 and the leader after round 10 is Cam Wilson on 43 votes. Let's go to our last three rounds.
Round 11, Corowa-Rutherglen travelled to Bunton Park to take on the North Albury Hoppers, a match that saw the Roos lead for the majority of the day. The game saw great games from Jason Marks with 17 touches and 3 goals, Darcy Melksham 19 touches and 3 goals, and Tom Goodwin delivering silver service to the midfielders with 14 touches and a season high of 48 hitouts. The Roos were too strong in the end, winning 13-8-86 to North Albury, 8-5-53. Round 12 and Corowa-Rutherglen returned to the John Ford Oval to play the Wangaratta Magpies, a game that saw some great performances from Cameron Wilson, 27 touches, and Joe Hansen, the captain, with 26 touches. The second place Pies were ultimately too strong for the Roos, making it a challenging game for the defenders. The Roos ended up going down by 18-14, 122 to 6-11, 47. With COVID interrupting the year again, the Roos had to come against the Wangaratta Rovers, which would be the last game of the season, with youngsters Jed Longmire and Ollie Struve making their senior debut. The game saw Corowa gain the lead after the half-time break with a lead of 8 points. A first goal to Jed Longmire and Ollie Struve was a highlight as they put on 5 goals and 27 touches between them. The Roos ended up winning a thriller 14-13-97 to Wangaratta Rovers 13-13-92.
Hanson takes the mark. He plays on. No. Our boy says no, he hasn't. And now he does. He wheels around. Kicks it deep inside 50 to Gia Longmire's direction. Longmire gets pulled down. Flavors gives a handball. Longmire.
Here we go.
Hand to Struve.
Oh! Yeah. He's got it!
Out. Gives a handball.
Oh,
13 minutes from the third quarter. Here's Mont.
The Cody shot kicks short, but well chopped off by Hayden Filippone. Gives a quick handball. Jed Longmire snaps around the body. And has kicked another one. Jed Longmire.
To extend the lead. Runs around.
Oh, Lefty Filippone nails it. 60 metres out.
Kick it, Sammy.
Kick it, Sammy. He found Gaston by himself over the back of George. One of the next. Drop what he probably would have taken if it was early in the day.
They're going to get it back.
Good tackle.
Well, it's a
big tackle.
What a win.
Okay, the last three rounds. Round 11 against North Albury. It was a positive win. I still felt we probably could have played a little bit better, but it was good to get a win back on the board. One vote, Taylor, Seymour, Nastasi. Two votes, Rose, Athenides, Cushett and Howard. Three votes to Grantham. Four votes, Goodwin, Lingham, Marks and Jack Shilg. Five votes, Melksham, Cam Wilson, Damien Wilson and Jared Lane. Round 12 against Wangaratta. All one voters there, Rose, Goodwin, Lane, Lingham, Cushett, Nastasi, Damien Wilson and Kyle Doherty. And three votes to Cameron Wilson. Round 13, possibly our, I would say definitely our best win. You could see with the singing the song then. It was just a really great day for our club. And for everyone to get involved, it was outstanding. We had some young players with young Jed and Ollie Struve. Did you see that bit of play where I think Ryan Ayres gave it to Jed? Jed gave it to Ollie Struve, who kicked the goal. I think the average age was about 17 and a half. So we had a really young team that day, and to beat a highly fancied opponent like Rovers, I just think it probably spoke volumes of where we're heading as a football club. So two votes, Athenides, Matty Wilson, Lavis, Geordie, Hanson and Howard. Three votes to Bradke, who kicked three that day, KB. Did you kick three? Did you notice Matty Wilson gave the handball off, didn't do a U-turn? So he actually listened to me in round four. That's why we did it, for those goals. Three votes, Logie and Bradke. Four votes, Longmire, what a famous name for the Corra Rutherglen Footy Club. Maxie Taylor, the Nagger, played a terrific game. He was hoping to build on his reserve votes that day, but mate, the senior votes don't go onto the reserves. But anyway, Scooter got four, played a terrific second half that game. Ollie Struve in his first game kicked three. Outstanding talent, really excited to have Ollie playing seniors next year, and Jack Shield on 4. 5 votes to Darcy Melksham, Cam Wilson, Kay Cushett, Matty Grantham and Ryan Ayres. Looking forward to, I think Ryan's just been at, I know he's here tonight. Have you had the talent camp yet? Has that been and gone? Yes, no? Nah. Well, don't drink too much tonight then, mate. and 6 votes that day was Jared Lane, and Hayden Filippone finished the season like he started the year on fire. Played a ripper game as a permanent for that game. So to the all-important results to finish off. Thanks, Pumper. Thanks for the comedy relief. Okay. So we see there, starting from the bottom, the two roommates, McGilvray and Jimmy Spark, hoping the boys can get themselves up for next year. Certainly Jimmy had a rough trot with his injuries. Mac Lavis, 2 votes. Struve, George Lovis, Jetty Longmire and the Naga, 4 votes. Mark Athanides, 5 on 9 votes. Ty Slogie, Scooter Seymour, Matty Wilson and Ryan Ayres on 10 votes, coming in 18th. KB, I'm expecting big things from KB next year. Yeah, no pressure there. 17th, Rosie, and same with Rosie. There's plenty of upside we'll get from a lot of players, but certainly Rosie only had a probably an average season to his standards. On 15th, Max Taylor and Kyle Doherty on 14 votes. Coming in 14th was Cody Howard on 17. Again, another player who I think's going to add so much more in. He signed in the last couple of days. 13th is Marksy, and I know Marksy is ready to go for next year. And on finishing in 12th was Gussie Lingham on 22. So our top 10, so an equal 10th on 24 votes, Joe Hansen and Charlie Anastasi. And again, Charlie signed up and Joey's ready to go. So Jack snuck into the top 10 on 27 votes. Well done, Jack. On 28 votes, in 8th position is Hayden Filippone. 1 vote ahead of him on 7 votes, and he's had a terrific year, Kush. He played some really good games for us in the back half of the season. 1 vote ahead of him on 6, in 6 on 30 votes is Matty Grantham in his first season at the club and in O&M. And again, I think Matty's going to be really good for us and important for us next year. Our top 5 in 5th position on 31 votes is our single shot warrior, Darcy Melksham. In 4th position on 37 votes, big Tommy Goodwin. And I know he'll be excited at back in Melbourne there, being out of lockdown. The frothies will be flowing, I hope not. In 3rd position on 44 votes, who moved as a permanent on-baller this year and played it to perfection. And that goes to Jared Lane. Well done, Jared. Our runner-up on 45 votes, Damien Wilson, 1 ahead of Jared. And Damien had a really consistent year. And our Jim Sandrell medalist on 56 votes. And certainly a player who hardly missed a training session, was as fit as anyone could be, committed in all areas. And our winner of the Jim Sandrell medalist for 2021 is Cameron Wilson. Well done, Cameron.
Thanks, Jermo. Congratulations to all the players, but particularly to Damien and Cameron on such a fine job. I don't know whether you saw the Cracker Brothers win it at North Melbourne, first and second, but it's the first time that I've known of brothers to finish first and second in our best and fairest. So a huge effort, but a very well-deserved effort from both Damien and particularly Cameron, because you've won the Jim Sandrell medal. Okay, we're going to have a short break. We'll finish our meals. I know Jermo will probably like to have a chomp down on his before we get going again. Have a quick drink and enjoy yourself for a few minutes before we roll into the presentations.
that dinner just like dessert too. And when we French refresh, give me two. When I bite that lip, come get me two. He want lipstick, lip gloss, hickeys too. Oh, kiss me, boy. We're so young, boy. We
gotta feed the streets. My pistol gon' bleed the streets. Ski mask on my face. Sometimes you gotta cheat to stay ahead in this bitch. Drank surf like it's liquor. Street life, I have you catching up to God quicker. Stick AK-40 to your lip. Let the chopper bang on you like a blood or a cripper. Flipper. So much bread, I'm a gymnast. Made so much money off of dummies, off of dummies.
Yeah.
Okay, everybody, we'll get back into the proceedings. A little bit more formal part of the night now where we present our wonderful award winners with their trophies. I'll just let all the guys make their way back to the tables. And a big thanks to Moose and the Corowa Free Press for attending tonight as well. We've certainly appreciated all the publicity that the Corowa Free Press gives us during the years. And Moose is a huge advocate for us. He makes sure that we get the back page or the front page whenever possible. So Moose, thank you very much for your efforts. Okay, so Georgie Bruce, I'm going to ask you to come up to the hang on a second, we'll just hold for 2 minutes.
You're a bit early.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, Georgie, if you could make your way up, we're going to move into some thank yous and some awards for the netballers. So girls, I know you're having an awesome night over there, Zoe, but we might just calm it down. Molly, can you just take them down a little bit? All right, let's show Georgie the respect she deserves as she reads out the awards for our netball girls.
I'm so glad I talked. Jesus, Craig. Talk about respect and you get whacked in the face with something that Craig's got on offer. Jeez. All righty, so I don't want to go on for too long. We know that we're always stuck for time and people get sick of sitting around, but it's really important to have a discussion and thank those that have made such wonderful years for us and all our volunteers. So for starters, with the netball, we've been working towards building ourselves up and we've gone ahead in strengths. Maddie? We've gone ahead, we've worked really hard. It's unfortunate that we didn't get to play last year, as I said earlier on, but I think that the night, if we continue to keep talking about the what could have beens and whatever, then that's what we hang on to. And I'm certainly not disappointed by the year that 2021 offered us. We had 3 out of our 4 netball groups that were going to end in the finals. Our 17s, it was going to be the first time we've ever had juniors that were going to represent in the finals. And that's not only a credit to the overall community and our us as a netball group being able to attract stronger players to have that success, but also to have people like Liv Sinclair who's been coaching them for the last couple of years. Also on that, and I just wanted to add it in, we've also had a great deal of success off the court. And we get up here and we talk about individual accolades or us as a team, but we've had some amazing things happen in 2021. We've had kids that have graduated from school. We've had people that have finally finished their university degrees. We've had birthday milestones, which I've been lucky enough to be a part of some of them. A wedding of 2 of our fantastic players, and then to follow it up with 2 engagements. So I think that... Give it a round of applause. So I think that whilst we can sit here and say, well, it's been a shit for the last 2 years that we haven't got the opportunity to play in finals, all these other wonderful life things have occurred and they're far more important. So with that, success is earned. As we know, it just doesn't happen. And we've always been really, really well supported at the club by all of our volunteers. Obviously, there's some people on a pay packet. But at the end of the day, our volunteers and our support people are the backbone of our club. And we want to make sure that we don't miss anyone out. So we'd like to, from the netball department, thank the board and the netball committee, Karen and the ladies in the kitchen, the past players and everyone else who helps out on a Thursday night with tea or at the gate. Our trainers, KG, Beck Van Melsen, Popeye, Mary Ram, Megan Hanrahan, all of you guys have played a role, whether it's been organising umpires, making sure that the courts are cleaned, ready for us to play, you know, strapping us up. Me personally, but also from the netballers, we definitely couldn't go without the likes of Liv and Sophie, and we're so lucky to be able to have playing coaches who have stepped in and at such a young age have such an amazing wealth of knowledge and experience, wonderful role models to the younger players that are coming through. Ro, who does multiple things here at the club and is always by my side, for me personally, Keezy McLean, Richie Mallows, who's our sports scientist that has assisted us, to all the parents and the supporters week in and week out that made sure that we were able to compete in what is such a successful and strong league in the Ovens and Murray. We'd like to thank personally our primary carers from the grades. So we had Brooke Dickens, Roslane, Kirsty Taylor and Marianne Spencer. And I would also like to thank and offer a gift, if Ro, you wouldn't mind. Well, actually, that probably doesn't work if it's Ro. Can I borrow you, Megan? For our team managers. Our team managers do a hell of a lot for us. They get our books ready, our backpacks, our bibs. They make sure the drink bottles are ready week in and week out. And in two grades, they at least listen to me swear my head off. So they definitely deserve a gift. So can I please call up Sandra Kennedy, Rachel Sinclair, Carmel Kingston, and Rowena Black? And to save me falling down the steps. I'm gonna let Megan can do the credit. Yeah, or do you wanna come up? Do you want to come up to get a photo? Yeah, all right. Megan's going to pass it and then you can come up and we'll do a COVID unsafe hug. For those of you watching at home, we're actually okay to have our masks off in New South Wales when we're sitting down at a function eating and drinking. So for those of you that are wondering, that's why we have them off and I'm talking. Oh, you've got to come up for the photo. Jesus, Sandra. For those of you who don't know, this is Sandra Kennedy, Gracie and Sophie's mum, Carmel Kingston, Roe Black, Rachel Sinclair's looking smoking in that Navy number. Round of applause for these lovely ladies, please. All right, now rack off. Nah. Don't fall down the steps, someone assist them. Oh, look at Kiwi working his charm. So we're so lucky at this club, as we've already touched on, Peter touched on it a little bit, and I think Stewie did in his opening speech, that we're such a well amalgamated club with our netball and footballers. And I'm a little bit longer in the tooth than some of you in this room, and I have played and represented at a few netball football clubs, and I'm sure as hell have not represented at one that is so well-binded as this one. And it's a credit to everyone in here, whether it be the people before us or those that are coming through the ranks now as the juniors. We all wear the blue and white, and we all brand ourselves as that one group of the Roos. And I think that watching the footy that Benny had put together, where we got to Rovers, the netballers had had a great day that day, but the season was capped off by that first win, and that meant more to all of us on that day than the however many wins that the A grade had had for the season. We were all so happy and celebrated in the one moment, which I think is what we're all about. So that comes from great leadership, us being amalgamated, and it does start at where we've had with the board, but especially from Peter. I know I haven't been quiet in saying that it's so nice and refreshing to be well respected by a firsts coach. And we've definitely worked really well together this year to try and bring the group even closer together, and going forward, I look forward to doing the same things to make sure that our group is as strong as it can be. Keeping with the football, we're really, really proud of how well the boys have progressed. We can read the articles and they say, oh, you know, Cora has won, but being a great club and having momentum is a feeling. And when you come down and you've got that feeling about you, and we can feel it for the boys that they've got great momentum and great leadership going forward, it's been really exciting to see all the boys who have signed up for next year coming up through the posts and whatever, and to see how many likes they're getting from the netballers and the funny jokes that are getting chucked around. It certainly is going to be a wonderful year going forward, and I think that you guys, you know, I think you're unlucky to not be making in the finals with a couple of those losses that we could have got as runs on the board, but next year I think it'll be much different. So well done, boys, we're really proud of you. And finally, obviously, we can't have a netball club without netball players, so a huge... Yes, Soph, and you. So a huge thank you to our girls. The sacrifice and the commitment that they've shown not only to their club but even to me. They've entrusted me for many years now. They keep getting in their cars and travelling down the highway, and I am so ever grateful for that and very humbled. They are truly a freaking amazing bunch of people. I really am lucky. I know that people say, well, it comes from the leadership, and I've just said the same thing, but I really am lucky that there's a team of people that have attracted the right sort of people to our club to make it the successful club that it is. There's a great buzz around the club at the moment. We've had momentum for 3 years, and having a chat with the girls prior to the netball trip and whatever, there's definitely still that fire in their belly to get the job done. Roo come up with a little thing that 2022 was the year of the Roo, and that's what we're going to stick with. So everyone keeps September in 2022 free.
Thanks, Georgie. And I'm sure everyone in the room loves it when Georgie talks about working together with Peter next year, because it cements her into that spot, right? She can't turn around and go anywhere else now. So thank you to you, yourself and your netballers. I think we've got two awards to give up here tonight, which are the most improved in our junior netballers and the most improved as a senior netballer. So, Georgie, I'll hand it over to you. I think Kiwi's rounding up the trophy there as we speak. Tell us a little bit about who are the most improved and why they improve so much.
Yeah, so we like to obviously recognise those people that have obviously stepped outside their comfort zone and showed great potential out on the netball court, improving their skills, but also sometimes it's about leadership and all those sorts of things. So in the juniors, we had a mixed bag team actually in the juniors. We had a great range of age. And as I said before, like it's obviously the most successful 17s or juniors team that we've had at Corowa since the beginning. And this girl in particular is one of the younger girls. And I thought I had a little bit of apprehension. I mean that in the nicest way, just because she was one of the young kids. And I said, we're going to have to take her under our wing. We're really going to have to cradle her and protect her from the ovens and Murray until she finds her feet. And she came out from the first game and was a leader and stood out and listened to everything that Liv had to offer, and myself, even when Liv didn't want me to offer it. And that is Steph Sutcliffe.
Okay, Steph, if you can make your way up.
Well, I don't know what to say. This is scary. Well, I guess first I'd like to thank my mum and dad for taking me to every netball game. Thank you. Secondly, I'd like to thank my coach, Liv. Right there she is. Congratulations. You've been a huge help, and I don't know what I would do without you, and I just want to thank you. I also like to thank Georgie, because... why not? Because she's just amazing. And of course, I'd like to thank my netball team. I love you guys. I'm just going to say it. I love you. Woo! And yeah, I'd just like to thank Cora Rutherglen. Such a great club, a great community. And I just love you all. And just love you all. And hope you have a great night. Woo!
Thanks, Steph.
Well, we're all feeling a little bit more loved tonight after that. the senior most improved player, it goes to another girl that was new to the club. She didn't get to play last year, but has been training hard. She's tried to vacate the building already tonight, which is in true Maddie style. But look, this girl, she was a superstar as a junior player, playing elsewhere at Wang Maggie's, and for whatever reasons, become ill-confident and has come to us. And I was a little bit concerned that we weren't going to get too far. Wasn't I, Maddie? But anyway, she's ended up coming through with the goods. So, Maddie O'Keefe. Ariana Titmus.
So this is most improved on the court, Georgie, or off the court as well? Both. Yep, very good performer both ways.
Thank you, everyone. And
No, I'd like to thank Georgie for being so welcoming and such an amazing coach, and all the rest of the netball girls for welcoming, and myself and Emma to the club. So, thank you.
Well done. The old pocket rocket. Well done. Okay, yeah, you're right, Georgie. You can have a little bit of a break. But Olivia Sinclair, if I can get you up now, and we will present the under-17s with their awards in what was a great season for our junior netballers.
Yeah, so this year I had the pleasure of coaching the under-17s again for the, I think, the third year in a row. This year was the first year we had an under-17s / under-16s team make the finals, which was a really amazing effort by my girls. And I think if we'd had a full season, we really would have seen the best of their netball towards the end of the season. So it was a very big effort by the girls, and I think we had about four girls that were bottom age, a couple of girls in the middle age, and then a few at the top. So it was a mixed bag, and to make finals against some girls, there was 14-year-olds playing against 17-year-olds, which in netball is a massive development difference. So it was a massive effort by the girls, and honestly, I've had the best year coaching these girls. They're all wonderful young ladies, and I could not be more proud of them.
Do I just say the awards?
Yep. So this year for my coach's award, I've picked a girl that has consistently showed up to training. She's sort of been my wing woman, I suppose, a girl that I've sort of relied on. And this year she's really stepped it up in her leadership skills, and I couldn't be more proud of the woman that she is becoming, especially as a netballer. So that award goes to Gemma Smith. Then our most consistent award this year goes to a girl that week in, week out, I could not fault her in any one of her games. She is, I would like to say, a mini version of myself. The runners-up award this year, as you can already tell, and we already know, is Steph Sutcliffe. She is an absolute ball of unassuming fun. I think if you guys were here on the hypnotist night, best person there. She's honestly a ball of fun, and every game she wants to improve and know her game better. And for a 14-year-old for most of the year, she put up with a lot of crap with her goalkeepers. So she, credit to her. Runners up for the year, Steph Sutcliffe. Then the best and fairest for our under-17s this year. The Kennedy family came over from Katunga this year. A massive, I suppose, change for them, and a great family to come to our club. We don't really get a lot of families that come from that way, but hell am I so happy that this family is here, because I couldn't have done it without her mum, Sandra, and Soph and Grace as a pair were amazing, amazing girls to coach. So this year, she showed great leadership. She was my steady girl in defence. I tell her to go somewhere and she'll do it, and she'll do it amazingly. So this year, our under-17's best and fairest was Grace Kennedy.
That's it. So we might get Grace up to just say a quick word. For those who weren't at our Thursday night selections and dinners, Georgie got up and spoke very glowingly of the Kennedy family during the year, about the sacrifice and the commitment they've made to the Coorabah Glen Football Club. And I guess it's just reward that Grace has won this best and fairest. But to all the Kennedys, fantastic effort, and we really appreciate what you've contributed to this club. Grace, are you going to come up and say a couple of words about your win and the great season you've had?
First of all, I'd just like to thank Mum for driving me an hour, me and Sophie an hour, to netball training and to games every week. Secondly, I'd like to thank Georgie. Without her, we wouldn't have been playing here this year and we would have missed out on so much. And lastly, Liv, on behalf of everyone, I'd like to thank you for supporting us this year, both on and off the court. You've helped us grow as players and as people, and we truly appreciate your sympathy towards sprinting and always being on the other... and always being on the other side of the phone when we want to talk netball, so thank you.
Well done. Congratulations to an amazing bunch of girls. It's been a very successful year, and we hope to see you all back in the Roos colours next year. Okay, Tommy Renshaw. Yes, I can see Tommy's making his way up here. Now we'll move from our under 17 netball awards through to our under 18 football awards. Tommy, I hope you've got a list there of the awards. Yep, all ready to go. So while the girls get their photos taken over there, Tommy will expound what the season was like from his point of view and let us know who the award winners were in the under 18s.
Yep, righto. So I'll just say a couple of words first.
Let's have a little bit of quiet.
First of all, I'd like to thank Craig and Dasha. A couple of years ago, they got me over to the club. I actually never thought I'd come to Corowa at all, but they conned me into it, and it was before COVID hit, and I was actually really, really excited about it. I've been here for obviously 2 years now. I think I've only coached 13 games. I think I've been locked out of the border about 9 times. Missed so many trains, which was tough, but I love the boys I had. Like, they were great. All the kids, they're very talented. And it goes to show tonight in the BNF, the top three are all underage, so they can all play again next year. So whoever is taking over next year will have a really good list. I want to thank all the captains, Dogger, Ollie, Jesse and Ned. A special thanks goes to Mark Osborne. When I was locked out, he'd take training, and Damien Meaton was the team manager. Special mention to Rizza for winning the goal kicking in the comp for a team that finished third last is a massive achievement for a kid that's only 17, and he has heaps of upside, I tell you. Sorry, I've just been locked out of my phone here. Another special mention is to Tracy Bush. Indy would come with me every Saturday. She loves the footy and loves the boys, and she's only 8, and Tracy looked after her every Saturday. So thanks a lot, Trace. I wish Ryan Ayres all the best in the achievements, what's going to come up for you, Ayrsie, and I wish you all the best, mate. Thanks to me family. All the time and stuff I allocate for footy, it takes its toll. And, I just want to thank them from the bottom of my heart, because if it wasn't for them, I wouldn't do it. But I will step away after this year and have a bit of a break away from coaching for a while, because I've done it for 9 years now. So I'd just like to thank the Coral Rutherland Footy Club for everything they've done. But I'll hook into the awards now. Is there any order?
Yep.
What order do you want to go? Thinking, oh, I'm not sure. I don't know what's going on here. And I've never had so many text messages off a player in me life. I'd start work at 2:33 in the morning and he'd still be messaging me at 9 o'clock or on the group chat. He doesn't stop talking and he does all the videos here. We all know who he is. He's got a big future in radio and whatever he's going to do. And I love him to death. And the Me Coaches Award this year goes to Benny Black.
Yeah.
Well, just want to thank all the boys for just the year we had. I want to thank Tommy. I want to thank also Oak FM for giving me the opportunity to call the seniors this year. And thank Mum for getting me to training. And yeah, just thank the club for all the opportunities you've given me. So yeah, thank you.
Well done, Benny.
I've never really heard a coach's award, you know, speech. That was good, Benny. All right, next award, most valued player. He's not here tonight. I was just talking to the boys about it up there. He's he is a different cat. I can tell you that right now. He debuted in the last game against Rovers. He's got plenty of upside, this kid. He's signed on for next year, I see. So the most valued player, I've given it to Ollie Struve. Our next award, another kid that's not here. Apparently he's working tonight. He actually followed me over from Rutherglen. He's got plenty of speed, plenty of talent, and I'm pretty certain he's staying here next year as well. And he's got a bright future in footy. It goes to Matty Holton. Most consistent. He could have actually played under 16s this year. And he got third in our BNF, could have played, 16s, but decided to test himself. He's got a massive, massive future ahead of him in the bush ranges and things like that. I love the way he goes about it. He never complains. He's hard. He's not as dirty as his old man yet, which is nice. But he does have a big future, and it goes to Finn Osborne. Next award, runner-up. Like I said, I've already spoken about him enough tonight. Won the leading goal kicking in the comp. Beautiful left foot. Uses his body super well. He's strong. He's got good height. It'll be really hard to stop in a few years. And it goes to Ryan Beveridge for runner-up.
I'll just mention that it's the Juice Kingston Award now.
Yep. Oh, does Ella come up?
Okay, just before Tommy welcomes up our Best and Fairest winner, obviously our Best and Fairest in the Under-18s Award is named after a previous champion at our club in John Kingston. John, as a lot of us knew, he was the life of the party. He was a Best and Fairest winner, a Premiership player, and a Morris medalist. So his line of credits was huge. He had a big impact on our club. He spent a lot of time with junior footballers at our club, whether it was through the under-12s, 14s and 16s, or the under-18s, and we felt it was more than appropriate to name our under-18s Best and Fairest after John. We're lucky to have his daughter Ella here tonight, who will come up and present the John Kingston medal. And Tom will just talk a little bit about our winner and why he was such a worthy winner.
So, it is an honour to talk about Juicy and with Ella up here with me tonight. And it even goes better that I am related to young Jesse. He is a bottom ager. I copped a lot of stick going to get Jesse from Wagunya. I had phone calls after phone calls. And you know what? I tell you what, I hope he stays in the ovens of Murray because he is good enough. He works so hard. You know, he's at the gym tonight before he gets here. Before school, he goes to the gym. You know, a lot of these kids here are putting time and effort in. And I'll tell you what, this kid really deserves it. And he racks up 30 every week, left and right foot. He works the contest after contest. I'd love to see how many Ks he clocks up, but I really hope he stays around here. It goes to Jesse Johnston.
Thank you, Ella.
It's an honour to win the GC Kingston Award. He was a great club man and a great family man. And I'd just like to firstly thank Mum and Dad for all their help throughout the year and getting me to the games and all that. Thanks to Tommy, Oz and Damo. They've helped us out, all the boys, through the year. And thanks to the boys. I know it was a hard one, but we'll come back for our own next year. Thanks to Jermo, Pumper and Dance and all the senior boys. Learned a lot from all yous. And yeah, thanks guys.
Well done, Jesse. Okay, before you guys leave, I can see Luke and Ned making their way up. I think they've got a little presentation to make. Ned's a natural in front of the microphone with his nice deep voice, so let's roll it off, Ned.
Yeah, that's loud. We'd just like to thank Tommy for coaching us for the past, he would have done it 2 years, but just this year because of COVID and that. But yeah, real hats off it to you on behalf of the boys. You know, you got no family here, but, you know, stepped up and, you know, come coach us, which we really appreciate. And we got a little something for you. Dog, I hand it over, mate. So, yeah, and, we got a couple of things. Marcus Osborne and Damien Minton, but they're not here tonight. They're elsewhere or something. But, and we just like to thank everyone else, all the boys and everyone who helped out the club. Thank you.
Thank you, fellas. As Tommy mentioned, he won't be taking on the role next year. For those who don't know, he lives in Rutherglen. Starts work in Corowa out at the piggery at 2 or 3 in the morning, fronts up for training, and then takes the boys through their paces. It's been a phenomenal effort, Tommy, and we appreciate the commitment that you've made. Just as the boys are getting their photos taken, and I hope they can listen to this while it's happening, the club has been fortunate enough to appoint a thirds coach for next year. George Sandrell came to our club this year as a senior player. Unfortunately, he injured himself early on and wasn't able to get out on the field. We were devastated because he's an exciting young talent. But not only that, he is a very mature young man. I know Peter German thinks extremely highly of him and speaks of him regularly. But George has offered to take on the under-18 role for next year. So congratulations, George. I know as a football department, we're very excited because the link between our under-18 coach and our senior coach is already there, and we know that that will grow through this year, and we'll have our whole club playing in a way that will take the whole club forward for a number of years in the future. The other exciting part of that announcement is that, it's a very tough job to take a group of under-18s, especially when you're only 20-year-old yourself. But Jamie Seymour has come on board as the assistant coach to George Sandrell. And we all know what a champion Jamie has been at this club over a number of years, and we think that will be a fantastic combination. We've got a couple of able-bodied parents there that will be helping out as well, and the future is very bright for our under-18 footballers this year. We are now going to move on to the C Grade Awards, Sophie. So if I can get you up here to tell us a little bit about why your girls have been so successful this year and who all the award winners were.
C grade this year, we had a pretty big list. I think we ended up having 12 girls. We had a relatively new team, and by around 13 games down, we just missed out on finals by a game, so it was pretty good. We had a few new girls into the team, and I think by the end of it, they went really well. So bear with me. Which one am I going first? So runner-up. Okay, so runner-up this year. no surprise. This girl, it was a bit awkward. Obviously, there's a bit of nepotism involved. She is my cousin, but I was very, very impressed with the way she trained this year. Her and another girl, Jade Lane, they both held around 80% attendance to trainings, which is pretty amazing. Like, you know, these two girls, they put in a lot of effort. They were determined. They stayed around for club functions. They stayed around, you know, for A&B training. And they, you know, even came to the netball trip, which is a pretty big deal. So it was awesome. So runner-up for this year, very proud of her. She played, I think, every position on the court except for defence. It goes to Lily Hanrahan. And we're cousins. Very proud.
Congrats! Why? I'd like to just thank, yeah, I guess Mum and Dad for coming to my games. Dad sometimes. I'd like to thank the girls. Yous were amazing. I loved yous. Yous made it 10 times better. And Sophia, even though you beat me every year in the A grade BNF, I guess I can let you go this time and thank you for giving me this opportunity. So thank you.
Well done, Lily. And Lily, I didn't realise you were such a big fan of the under 18s because I've never seen a girl clap so hard as what you did when we announced George Sandrill over there. So. Great to see your supporters behind George as well. Sophie's just choking on a chicken bone at the moment.
You're a comedian, Craig. That's funny. Most consistent this year, so we just want to outline. So most consistent goes to the person who polled in the most amount of games. So, you know, this year I was very happy kind of with who got most consistent because I also actually got my coach's award. This girl, she's come to the club a few years ago and she's just a funny little girl. She doesn't say much, but when she says it, it's gold. So she's definitely improved. She was part of the C grade team last year and also a part of the B grade team who won the premiership last year. This year she was the only girl to attend. She only missed one training for the year. She put in a lot of effort. Her mum was our primary carer, I think. She's just an amazing girl, and it goes to Jade Lane. So, who unfortunately can't be here tonight. So, yeah, shut up, Jade. I think that's... Yeah. this goes to now the BNF for tonight. So this goes to Beck Cushett. So Beck's been around in our C-grade team for the last few years. She's such an integral part of our C-grade team. She's won a league BNF in C-grade, which should not go unnoticed. She's a part of our C-grade team who were in a grand final last year and our B-grade team on the bench. She's a constant... extra player in B grade as well. She's always at training, even if she can't train. She's such a great club person, as is her family. And, yeah, it's just awesome to be able to reward her with C grade BNF for tonight.
Beck, I think you should be a natural at coming up and saying a few words now. Have you got... No, you decided to take the silent stand. Okay, Sophie, have you got a couple more to go?
I just want to thank Rachel Sinclair and Roz Lane as well. Thank you for this year.
Okay, thanks, girls. You've had an amazing year. We think, Jess, you might be missing your cue there. Yep, Jess is going to make her way up. And I'm sure Jess has got a few nice words to say about her coach this year, correct?
I just want to thank Sophie for this year. Honestly, it was an up and down year for us. We had a few injuries, which obviously didn't go our way. But I definitely think if we had those last few rounds, we probably would have been in the finals with the other girls, which would have been great. All four netballers in the finals. Thank you for all your time and dedication. being my sister-in-law, you know, pretty close now. But yeah, thanks for the year, and thanks for all the girls as well. You did great.
Well done, girls. Let's put our hands together for a fantastic bunch of netballers, well led by a great coach in Sophie Hanrahan. Okay, Georgie, we're going to ask you to come back up again and tell us all about the year that was for the B graders and who the main contributors were that won your eye and won your awards for the year.
I've been told to keep it short, but seeing as though football always takes the amount of time that they want, I'm not going to be pressured. So, B-grade this year, we were obviously trying to make sure that we stayed at the top of the ladder after having such a successful year in 2019, and we're able to do that with a pretty much a brand new team. But they've had a great year. We'll get named at the Ovens and Murray Morris Medal as minor premiers, I'm hoping.
KB.
Yep. CEO's nodding at me, so that's always a good sign. So without further ado, because I've been dinged, the Coaches Award fortunately goes to Kiara McLean. Unfortunately, she was unable to be here due to not having a second jab. But as we know, everyone knows Keezy. She's a positive machine. She's ever reliable. She's the girl that digs in deep when you need the job to get done. So she can't be a better award winner. No, she's Kiara McLean. She's Lightning McLean. So round of applause for Keezy. Most consistent, as Soph said, goes to the girl that polled in the most rounds outside of the top two. And this year it goes to Lisa Tobin. So as she's making her way up, Lisa came to us at the start of last year but obviously didn't get to play and has got better week in, week out. She's an absolute dream to coach. She takes on everything that you say, asks for feedback, trains hard, messages me during the week. She's just an absolute godsend, and we're so happy to have her here at the club for multiple reasons. So, well done, Lisa. The runner-up best and fairest, as we saw before, is Lily Sharp. Lil's come across this year as well. We're really lucky to snag her right at the start of the season, and she's... she didn't need a lot of coaching. She's already pretty phenomenal. So we're very lucky to have her, all-rounder defender. Thank you very much, Lily. And our best and fairest winner for today, who's in fine form, and I can't wait to hear her speech, is Zali Spencer. Look, I've said it more than once this year. Zali Spencer was the unnamed A grader playing in B grade, and she certainly led with example. She's a fantastic player, versatile, can play from one end to the other, and just has that X factor about her. She's honestly been one of the best players that I've had to deal with it whilst I've been at the Roos, so couldn't come across a better winner. She's not in her best form right now, but anyway, she's going to give it a crack.
Okay, Zali, I know you enjoy being up here on front of the stage, so how about saying a few words about your season?
So most of the year we've trained as an AB squad, so we're actually going to award Georgie a present together as an AB squad. So we're going to do it after the A-grade awards and together because we've been together the whole year. We've been together the whole COVID lockdowns, the isolation, you know, all that. So we're going to do it together. But congrats to our other girls that have won our awards this year. We've had a great year, and to make it as minor premiers, we've done a really good job, girls.
Thanks, Ali. And thank you, girls. You did have a fine season and one that is truly amazing. Okay, Daniel Athanitis, if I can get you back up to the stage, mate. We will we'll go through the reserves awards before we will have a quick break and a quick chat to some of our Melbourne guys. Okay, Daniel.
First things first, I won't keep you too long, but I'd like to thank the football club again for the opportunity, coaching. A lot of people that I already previously knew in the community and things like that that sort of, yeah, got me here to be involved, which was great. Thanks to Germo. Thanks especially to Dancer. Dancer would ring me every day. I knew what he had for breakfast, lunch and dinner. But he can't be here tonight. I don't know why, but I tell you now, if we all had the passion and the endeavour to get things done that Dance has got, I think the place would be travelling along pretty well. So we're in good hands as far as that's concerned. So obviously my wife, she's not here tonight, but she makes things easy for me to commit to sport and things like that. She always has. So. And, yeah, thank you very much. We'll get to the awards. Oh, most determined goes to a fella. I've known him for a while. When I first met him, he had really long hair and bowled little off spinners, but he's grown into a man now. And, you know, had a really, really good season. He started a bit ordinary. He was a bit underdone, but once he got to training... And, started getting a kick. I tell you now, Bacco, you had a really good year. So well done to Bacco, most determined. We'll get her cracking. Yeah. Well done, Bacco. Coach's Award. Now, Coach's Award's a funny one. The amount of support he give me by turning up every week. He came to training. I told him a couple of times if he kept shaking his head, it was going to fall off. But he's not here tonight, which I'm not really happy about. But his name is Jed Ansell, and he won the award. So well done to the Jed. Really, really proud of the progress he made. And look, hopefully he sticks around because you need blokes like that at your footy club. Most consistent goes to a bloke. I only met him sort of at the start of the year at the footy camp. Really impressive fella. Bought into the footy club as soon as he got here. He told us that he wasn't going to play, he wasn't going to do this, wasn't going to do that, but I think he got itchy feet and was a really, really good player for me. And that goes to Stretch. So well done to Stretch McGilvray. Most consistent. He's got a bit of a shock. Oh, so runner-up in the BNF, we all know who got that. Another fella, he started a bit late. He jumped on board, had a really, really good season. I think he could really be a really good footballer for the footy club. And that goes to Willie Seymour. So well done to Willie. And the best and fairest winner. Really proud of him. He buys into everything you want to do. He's easy to coach. He gave me a lot of support throughout the year. He stepped up and played some senior footy under Germo, which was really, really positive for the club. And that goes to the Nagger. So well done to Bailey Pernag.
Start off with thanking Pumper for the year for coaching us and to Dance and Germo for all the help they did with us. Thanks to all the boys, the ones that filled in and the ones that were there week in, week out, no matter the result. Shame to only get the one win, but I reckon that one win was enough for us to keep pushing through the year. Thanks to everyone tonight for putting this on, and thanks, Luke Backhouse, for teaching me how to kick better.
Thanks, guys. Definitely had a very good year socially, so that makes up for a lot of the pain on the field. Obviously, we had some great new guys at the club this year that travelled down from Melbourne each week. I think if our technology is working right, we're going to cross over to them now. I know Benny, our man of many talents, has been at me to get this hookup going. And if we get it right, we should have Tommy Goodwin, Jason Marks and Charlie Nastasi on the big screen. The South Corowa Roosies dubbed them. So just while we're waiting for that hookup, if I can, Neil Chardy, if you could just make your way up this end of the hall. You're next in line with your presentation, so, and Gary Cook, Neil and Gary, if you guys could come up this way just while we're tuning in. So here we are, Charlie Nastasi front and centre, Tommy Goodwin, Jason Marks. Thanks, guys. Thanks, guys, for tuning in. Obviously, you made a terrific impact at the Corowa-Rutherglen Football Club this season. We're disappointed that we couldn't have you here for a few of the games that we played, but also for this presentation night because, you know, Tommy, you've got a huge reputation on the football field, but you've got a huge reputation off as well, and they reckon you do some of your best work at presentation night. But
He does.
But Tommy, the coach, Peter German, he's been talking you up right through since football season finished. He believes that you're doing an enormous pre-season down there in Melbourne and that you're going to come back and make an impact on the Ovens and Murray like we've never seen before. Can you enlighten us on what your training program looks like so far?
Well, as we're... Charlie, can you please get out of the way? Of course, at the moment, as we're celebrating today, as well as the best and fairest night for the club, but today's the first day we've been allowed out of the house by law, so, we're actually enjoying ourselves a little bit too much. Everyone's calling it Freedom Day down here in Melbourne, but... we've been doing a bit. Myself, Jason and Charlie, we've got a bit of a training program now. And then obviously Will Robinson and Jai Lane and Billy Hansen. We're going to work out their training program, especially if we stay down here. We're all trying to get up here as soon as we can, obviously, to Cairo. I don't know how to talk to which way we're on. We're going to this one or we're going to that one. I don't know. I'm the worst person in the world with technology, so... I'm commenting from all angles, but I can't wait to get up and at least just catch up with the boys, obviously with Pete himself. And obviously this year was interrupted quite extremely, but at the same time, me, Jason and Charlie were just talking before about how much we actually just enjoyed it as a football club, everything else that even the short time we had up there, I mean, 11 games, and even those 11 games were quite interrupted. But even those 11 games where we came up and we were embraced by the community and everything else, I thought coming on from here, and when the question was to sign on again, there was never no qualms with myself. I don't know where the other boys, I'm not going to speak for them, but I had an absolute ball and I just can't wait to get up and really get fit and work with the other boys and really strive for a stronger 2022 season.
Fantastic, Tommy. Great to have you signed up again for next year. Charlie, I know that you've enjoyed yourself. You've been well and truly accepted in because you're such a personable guy. You have been training because we know you get the shirt off and you get in the gym and you whack it up on social media at any opportunity. But how is your body feeling and are you ready to light up the Ovens and Murray in 2022?
Stand up. Shirt is on tonight. Apologies, everyone. We didn't want that. But feeling good. Excited to be back next year. Excited to see everyone actually experience playing at Corowa in full, because I feel like we didn't really get that experience this year. So we're looking forward to it. Myself, we're all looking forward to it. So thank you.
Well, Charlie, we're excited to have you back, and it really is an exciting 2022 coming up. Jamar, you're the leader of the pack, and obviously we've got three other guys coming up from Melbourne this year. Have you been out and purchased a new Bongo van, or how is everyone travelling up next year? Is it going to be one big happy family moving up the highway?
We're in the market at the moment. We've been searching Gumtree far and wide at the moment, and I think we found a little Mercedes van for the six of us to join up. We've called ourselves the Deep South Corowa Ruse, and that's something that we're really looking forward to joining together and possibly having a few training runs and coming up the highway together to join up for Corowa.
Fantastic. Well, the sun's out up here now. You guys are out of lockdown. We hope to see you as soon as possible. Big round of applause for our Melbourne contingent. It's been amazing to have you on board. Okay, we'll move on. Part of having a great club, of course, is our great volunteers and the great people that we have around the club. We have a fantastic bunch of trainers that work extremely hard, that put in an amazing amount of time down at our club. Not only are they great with what they contribute as far as their medical knowledge, but they have been engaging in so many ways. They've set a new standard at this club. They also came to the board with a bit of a proposal at the start of the year about how they would like things structured. So they were very much on the front foot. And I'd like to hand over to the trainers now, Neil Chardy and Gary Cook, and they have got a little bit of a presentation that they would like to make. Sorry. Reg Clancy's also there in the background, and he's been integral as well. Sorry, Reg, didn't see you there.
Thanks, guys. At the beginning of the season, a meeting of the trainers took place where it was decided that they would forego any payment and remain as volunteers. As part of the agreement with the club, a new award has been created that the trainers would give to a winner of their choice. The award is to recognise exceptional club spirit and attitude of helping fellow club members and being a role model for those around them. This award will be named the Trevor Cushett Trophy in recognition of the selfless contribution to the ongoing improvement of this club. Could I please call Beck Cushett forward to present this year's trophy to the winners of the trainers have chosen two members to share this year's award. Firstly, a young lady who is not only a fierce competitor on the court, but also helps coach and advise the other grades, as well as fulfilling her commitments to duties around the club. The co-winner this year is a young bloke struck down with a season-ending injury on Neil's shift before the year even began. He could have disappeared, but instead was at the club doing rehab and helping with game day duties each week. Could you put your hands together for these truly inspirational young people, this year's co-winners, Liv Sinclair and George Sandrell.
You shouldn't have to.
Congratulations, George. All done, mate.
Good boy.
Okay, as well as the Trevor Kutcher trophy, the trainers have also donated a piece of sporting equipment for use by the club, hopefully helping with fitness and rehab for years to come. And we'll have a picture of it there any second. Maybe not.
Fantastic. The new exercise bike. I'm sure that'll be well and truly put to great use, Cookie.
On a personal note, I'd like to thank the team of trainers, Neil, Reg, Tony and Daryl for their efforts this year, Stuart and the great committee, the club coaches and all the players for their support. Thanks, guys.
Thanks very much, guys. Thanks, Cookie. Fantastic, Evan. I think you can tell by what's just been presented there, we have one of the most progressive groups of trainers in the Ovens and Murray. And I know our footballers and our netballers are just so pleased to have them around that it's not funny. Okay, our next award is another volunteer award. It's the Mick Houlihan Clubman of the Year Award. Stuart's going to present that award now. Just to give you a little bit of a recap, the Houlihan family have been integral parts of this club for many, many years. Mick, who passed away about 15 to 20 years ago, was here, you know, all the way through his adult life. He volunteered for any job that was going out, and he never once asked for any thanks. He was the epitome of a volunteer at our club, and hence the reason why this award, the Volunteer of the Year Award, is named after Mick Houlihan. So I'll now hand over to Stuart, who will present the award to our Volunteer of the Year.
Thanks, Craig. There's an old saying that volunteers are the lifeblood of football clubs. And what we've heard in the last half hour holds true for the Corra-Ruther Glen Football Netball Club. The amount of work that is done behind the scenes by people that keeps this club on the track, in the canteen, etc., etc., is nothing short of amazing. And I've seen it this year firsthand. The number of people and the work they do is fascinating. So this award recognises that work. But unfortunately, there's only one person who we can make the award to, which makes it a very difficult decision to come to. But the person we've chosen this year has worked tireless hours at the club. She's conscientious in her role, led a fairly big team of people who have contributed solidly also, and her efforts have resulted in a financial support for the club. So this year, the Mick Houlihan Volunteer of the Year Award goes to Karen Bradkey. So congratulations, Karen. Unfortunately, Karen's not with us tonight, but we hope that she's looking in somewhere. Or KB, you might come forward. KB's going to do something for his mother. Congratulations to Karen. If you'll take
proud
that
of
home.
You, Mum.
Thanks, Craig.
Okay, a man of few words, but very pertinent. Well done, KB. Okay, we'll now move on to our A-grade awards. So, Georgie, I'm going to ask you to come back up and outline what a fantastic season our A-grade netballers have had. They've been an inspiration to our club for a number of years now. They've led the way as far as success goes, and every award that they get tonight is very well deserved. So, Georgie, let us know who they were and tell us a little bit about why they got those awards.
Yep. No wuckers. Oh, Rose, come on over. Yep, so the A-graders, once again, David's going to nod where you get named as the minor premiers for the A grade. Yep, brilliant. So top of the ladder, that is going to have to do this year. We'll have to take it. As I said before, there's a fire in the belly and we're definitely not going to give up until we walk away with that cup. So the Coach's Award goes to someone who's ever reliable, super creative, always thinking on how to improve our game, shut down other people's games, improve the club, what we need to do around the place, and she just got pretty much an award for that exact reason, and it's Liv Sinclair. Don't you roll your eyes at me, Olivia. Most consistent award this year. Unfortunately, she wasn't able to be here, but it's probably the best year I've seen her play since her junior times. She just keeps getting better and better and has had a wonderful year in defence, and that's Em Larrissey. The runner-up best and fairest was Grace Senior, who also is unable to be here. But Gracie, if any of you saw this year, put a wonderful article out in the Border Mail raising awareness around mental health and anxiety and how people suffer in silence from it. And I think it just goes to prove the sort of year that she's had. She's matured not only on the court but off the court and really found herself comfortable in her own skin. And I know that if she was here, she'd be thanking Jess Bice for some of that. So well done, Gracie. And who was the BF winner?
Oh, it's hard.
I'm not really sure who it was. She has a collection of trophies. So fresh. Would you like to make your way out the front? Look, we are really lucky to be blessed with Sophie. She's a good country chick at heart. She's homegrown, bred, come from Kareen across to us here at the Roos. She's a superstar. She's humble and has been, which has been on the down low. Been on the down low, but last year, it's this year, isn't it? We went down to Melbourne, went down to a V&L club and did some training, and they liked her so much that she's been invited to come trial for them to play V&L this year. So truly a great player.
Liv just said no one gives a shit about the Coaches Award, so I thought I would share that with the room. I just want to firstly say thanks to Georgie. I know I've probably made a bit of a love letter to her throughout my last few speeches, but she's kind of... Oh, thanks, Holly. She's kind of the reason every one of the netballers are here tonight. I don't think it should be underestimated how much of an impact Georgie has had on each and every one of our netball lives, and not actually, sorry, our netball lives, our personal lives. The fact that after every single game, every A and B grade netballer, sorry C grade, I don't do the same, but after every game, Georgie sends each A grade, B grader a detailed paragraph long message of what we did right and wrong. Improve on. It is just amazing, and I find it very interesting. I just want to actually say thank you to Jermo as well. It's been really lovely to have a football coach kind of get on the same wavelength as Georgie, because it obviously proves what she's on is a winning formula. So, yeah, I don't know. It's great to see the footy boys getting around the netballers, and, you know, this isn't normal. I think at other football netball clubs, it's actually not very normal for netballers and footballers to get along. So, yeah, thanks to Jermo for getting on that train. We really appreciate it. So just congrats. Yeah, can you just put your hands together for Georgie and Jermo? I actually just want to say thank you to my mum, Mez Hanrahan. She can't be here tonight because she's single vaxxed, but she's watching at home. She did donate... hey, Mez! She doesn't want anybody to know this, and it is me obviously being a bit biased because she's my mother, but my mum has donated each of the Netball Coaches Awards because she believes that there should be a Coaches Award. The coaches should be able to distribute award on who they think has proved themselves this year. So
And as you guys may have noticed, Mum went on a bit of a haul last night and uploaded all of the bloody photos from this year, which is a bit weird, but yeah. Daysdale must have had really good MBN last night because she went on a bit of a spree. But yeah. Hey, Mum. Love you and Dad. And yeah, so Georgie, we just want to present from behalf of A and B grade. Thank you so much. We love you so much. We actually can't. This is not a representation of our love. We will never be able to represent how much we love you. Thank you so much for the past 2 years.
Thanks, Soph, and I wish us all the very best next year. We'll let you know who the new coach is sometime soon. I'm kidding, Ro. I'll see you next year.
Thanks, girls. So, Sophie, you might want to take these ones with you.
Oh, thank you.
That's okay. Okay, so we've got, we're going to ask Jermo to come up and do his awards. On his way up, though, those who filled out the questionnaire, you've gone into the draw for $150. Jermo's going to draw one out of the middle there. He's not going to look. So thanks to Hetherington Plumbing, we've got a winner that we're about to announce. And the winner is Jimmy Ayres, a former plumber himself. Jimmy Ayres, you've won our Working at Heights Let's Get It Right prize of $150. So if you catch up with Kiwi, you'll be able to collect that prize. Okay, Jermo, tell us about our senior footballers and how their season panned out.
Thanks, Craig. Doing a great job. I have to lower it because Sophie must have super high heels on.
Righto, let's quieten down. Just give Jermo some respect.
I know it's a long night and everyone's sort of... It's getting to the pointy end of the night, so... to finish off, and I think there's a special surprise tonight, isn't there, Craig? You're going to announce at the end for everyone, certainly the young people, but I know Neil and the cookie and the trainers, they'll love it as well. But look, it was I guess I come in as my first season as coach, not really sure what to expect. When you're getting a new group of players, it is... I guess the first thing you've got to try and do is win them over and try and sell a plan and you're trying to sell a plan and you're trying to get a lot of things across to try and build the club. And I guess, you know, we have become, when I say we've become, we've been a team that I get that people just think, oh, you know, Cora Rutherglen, you know, they're just going to be down the bottom somewhere. Well, we've got to try and change that. And from the day that I come into this football club and netball club, I've seen it as one big whole club, and it's past players and it's everyone involved. It's only not just about the footballers, it's about everyone. But certainly from the footballers' perspective, it was about how we're going to try and build this club to really start to earn respect and start to climb up the ladder and then start to show people that we're just not this club that's just not going to... except where we're at, but we're going to really push hard to go forward. So I think that I spoke to Stu the other night. I think we've jumped that first hurdle. We won 40% of our games this year, and I think the last time we went anywhere near that was, I think, 2014. So to be able to win 5 out of our 13 games, and I really felt that the back end of the season was when we were going to play our best football. So I would have hoped that we would end up winning sort of maybe 7 or 8 games by the end of the year, and that was that first hurdle that we needed to jump. And I still believe that we did that, and certainly that last game against Rovers, where we had our youngest team for the year, and I think it showed not only the players but everyone and the whole competition that we're not this club that's just going to, you know, go through the motions and just finish down the bottom every year. So from that point of view, we've really worked hard so far off-season. We've recruited really well. Hats off to Dancer and to Craig and the board, who have really started to take some really good steps going forward. But I guess from just to recap on this season, I'd like to thank Stu, Ro, Craig and the board, because it is a tough job. And you ask Liv, who come onto the board this year, and the people, it really is a thankless job, and the time and energy you got to put into it is really tough. And to be honest, I think we've got a lot of people who do a lot of volunteering here, in which many hands make light work, but there's still, to me, there's is even like even more to do. So we've got to try and get even more, I guess, from the board and anyone else who's willing to get on board, because I think that's what makes a great club. And I think we are a great club, but we want to be one that's really sustainable and seeing a great vision and everyone going forward. And that's, I guess, the board's role now to create that vision. I'd like to thank the members, the volunteers, certainly the trainers. You guys are fantastic, because I've been to a lot of clubs, and I think Tommy said he's been coaching for 9 years. Well, this is my 27th year of coaching, so even though I don't look that old, I know that. that's a joke, by the way. You're allowed to laugh, Kiwi. I'm older than you, Kiwi, by the way, I think. But to have a group of trainers that you guys, that what you're willing to do and the effort and what you've even done tonight, I can tell you now, a lot of clubs can't even get trainers, let alone have a group that we've got. So I really thank you guys for your time and effort this year. And we talk about volunteers, and we've got great volunteers, but I put it on Facebook one night, and I even said it to the players, and I said, this is what people are willing to do for you guys to get out on the field. We had a home game. I come down about 9:30 to print some names up on the computer down the club rooms, and there's the lights are on in the canteen. And I'm thinking, who's in the canteen at 9:30 on a Friday night, before Saturday? I come in, and I look in, and there's Karen Bradkey. And I'm just thinking, this is what it's all about. And I said, what are you doing here? She goes, no, I'm just making stuff for tomorrow and all this sort of thing. And I'm thinking, well, when you coach and when you play, and I tried to make the players realise that these people, what they're doing, to actually try and make this club better and make it function, it's outstanding. And, Karen obviously won something tonight, but I know that there's a lot of people, and my old mate Graham Barry, who I've known since I was 4 years of age, and I was still best mates with his son. And I know Graham's done a lot of work. Like, he struggles now, obviously, with his back and that, but never missed a home game. And to me, that's what I love about this club. And that's what inspires me to want to try and keep making this club, not only where we're at, we're going to make it better. We're going to make this club 10 times better. So I want to make sure I know I do drive people mad. I drive Kiwi mad and Ro and everyone. But that's just my way of trying to push people to try and make this club better. Because as I say, and you can look at great names, and you just heard them all night, Cushett, the Sandrills, Longmire, Houlihan's, the Ayres, the Spencers, and I know there's probably another 20 or 30 that we could rattle off. But these people have been integral to this club. But again, that's what I love about football clubs and sporting clubs, that you carry on the tradition or you carry on their legacy. And I know Jimmy's here tonight to be able to present the medal. I want to thank the players. I want to thank their families and their partners and everyone, because, again, to play country football, there's so many people who have to do a lot of things. We've got farmers, we've got people who have to travel, a lot of guys. We've got our Aubrey group, Damo, and all the boys, and Jared, who live in Aubrey, have to travel. Jess, and I know you're going to travel again next year, which is great. Jared told me, so you're on. But, again, just their families. I want to thank, as I say, mums and dads and partners, because I don't get to see them. I went out to the Wilsons last night, and I just love going out to see the two girls because I love making them cry. As soon as they see me, they just start crying, not sure why. Damo, you've told them something about me, haven't you? Anyway, our sponsors, really important. I think that next year we've got to do better in terms of our sponsorship and our networking, and to be able to make them really feel a stronger part of it, and hopefully I can play a little bit of a part in that. So I'm looking forward to that. And certainly thanks, Georgie, for all your support. And at times their support, and there's times of driving me mad. And it's probably a bit of 50-50. But our brainwaves are certainly on the same wavelength. So it's great to always talk to you about how we can get better, but also the Netties. I really look forward to seeing you guys continue to keep going as a powerhouse that you've been. And I guess in terms of my footy department, I just want to make sure I thank, which is Daniel Athanides, thanks. I know, Pumper, in the box I gave you a couple of little clips, but that wasn't because I don't rate you, it's because I actually do rate you. And I really like your way you go about your football thoughts. Dancer, Dave Melksham, if you're at home, I know he actually was flipping between the races, or must have been Shin Tan or something like that over in Hong Kong or something. He must be watching them. But thanks, Dancer. Your work has been mighty, and what you're doing now is outstanding. To Damian Wilson as assistant coach, thanks, Damo. That was... I know you're going to take a step back next year, but certainly your leadership and direction, you know, and that was shown by also how well you did tonight. Georgie Sandrew in the box, probably had the most thankless job of doing the rotations, but it's probably the most important. George, you've done an outstanding job, mate. I really take my hat off to you, and I congratulate you on your award, and next year going forward as a reserves under 18s coach. And Joey Hansen as well. Joe was never... an official assistant coach, but Joe basically, any time that we split up, he always had the back line and took control of them. So I really thank you, Joey, for your time and efforts. And also, I want to thank Dave Logie. Good on you, mate. I thank you for your time and your effort. Probably won't be with us next year, but, mate, regardless, mate, I really appreciate what you did and the support you gave me this year. To Greg Filippone, good on you, Greggy. Mate, in the box, you enjoy that? You enjoy being in the coach's box? It's good fun, isn't it? But, mate, what you did as well was outstanding. I really thank you for your time and your effort. So thanks for that, mate. And also, Trent White. Now, is Trent here tonight? Mate, he come on board as our property, and what he did for us this year to be able to make sure the footy's always in great nick, because I'm a footy Nazi. Mate, no one can touch them, and they've got to be in good nick because they are the tool of our trade for the players. And Trent did a fantastic job, and I know he's keen to do it again next year, so thanks to Trent. And finally, can I just say in terms of thanks, I know my family's watching. I haven't seen them for over probably 4 months now. You know, it's a big step to be able to leave your family to come up here. They haven't been able to come up. I haven't been able to come down. They've always been a part of my football life. So... they're even hoping to get here this week, but obviously couldn't get up because of the regulations. But I know they're at home. They've been texting me madly. But to my wife, Kathy, and all my girls, thanks very much for your support and just being allowing me to do what I do, which is I just love coaching footy and I love being involved in footy clubs. And certainly I'm really enjoying my time at Corra or Rother Glen. So thank you to my family. Righto. Enough thank yous. Let's get into the good stuff. Well, firstly, I think we've got the best first-year player. Would that be fair to say?
That would be.
The best first-year player. Have we got it up? Are we coming up? Okay, so basically the Rookie of the Year award goes to a guy. I think I said to him at pre-season, I said, you train hard. And I reckon I'll give you a game. But deep down, I knew that this kid was going to pretty much play every week. I said something, you know, desperately, is it going to have to go wrong for him not to play? And he played every game. And I thought he was he's terrific. Funny, when you get up here, people are quite quick to tell you certain things. And someone would say, you know, what about this guy? And they go, yeah, he's great, but. And then you got this other guy, and he's great, but, oh, but he's this. And I got a bit of that with this guy, but he never missed a training session, trained his heart out, and I thought he had a super year and even finished fifth in the best and first, and the best first year player goes to Darcy Melksham. Have we got him on? Oh, look out. Hello.
I think here we are. So Darcy's brought it up. So, Darcy, great to see you're partying at home there while the Roos are out here partying. But it's been an impressive year for you. When Peter German came to the club, I know a guy like you would have been nervous as hell about what he was going to bring to the club and what he was going to do to young guys like you. But how did you find Germo, and what did he do to lift you up to have such a great season?
I reckon he has developed my footy. From like 2 years ago, I played a few games in my first year, and like when I was coming up from 16s, I was pretty scared of like all the other boys. But this year, it's like he's developed me a lot. But I don't really know what to say on. He's given me good confidence.
Hey, Das, what about the last game when you didn't have a kick up to half time against Rovers?
Spray over.
Hey?
You gave me a massive spray, yeah. But you told me to pull my finger out, and I did, so.
Yeah, and he went down Media Street again. Didn't you get an award? No. Anyway. Hey, so is Dad telling you what to say, or is he at the Dapto Dogs?
No, he's always in my ear.
I don't think anyone knows, and I don't know if it's official yet, but... Doesn't matter. All right, mate. Hey, listen. Congratulations on your... where is it? Over there. Best first-year player. I think that it was well-deserved. And what do you think you're going to do next year? What are you going to give us next year? What's your aims and what's your goals for 2022?
We'll just keep doing what I was doing this year, but obviously... Keep getting better and stronger. And doing the best that I can for the team, obviously.
I like your attitude, Das. And, mate, you're a great player. You've been a good young player, but I think you're going to develop into one of the great O&M players, and where football takes you, who knows. But well done, mate. Congratulations on becoming the best first-year player.
Thanks, Das.
Thanks, Jerry.
Round of applause for Das.
Righto, our next award is... I haven't got the runner sheet here, have I? You've dudded me, Craig. Just put the next screen up and I'll know it. Next slide. No, it's not that one. Most improved. Could have gone to a couple of guys. How do you work most improved? Is it from the year before, or is it from the start of the year or whatever? So, to be honest, it was probably a bit of... where he'd come from and from the start of the year and where he ended up. And to this guy's credit, I think early on, a couple of times I could have choked him. I think some of his teammates could have as well. But I felt that he was learning all the time, which is the main thing that we're always asking for in our environment, that you're learning. We keep teaching as coaches, and I thought this guy continued to keep getting better and better. He played in a position that was foreign to him, and I thought by the end of the year he was very productive in it. But I think that there's what I'm excited about. He's going to be plenty of upside for next year. And our most improved goes to Max Taylor. So Maxie's not here tonight, so what's the next award is the Kiwi? Okay, so the players were asked to nominate a 3-2-1 for their most valuable player. So their most valuable teammate. So we call it the MVP Players Award, which in many ways is fairly prestigious. It's a peer group type award, and I think that anyone who wins this should feel very privileged that obviously their teammates value them as teammates, but also what they contribute to the club. And I think we've gone from a 3-2-1, because can I say, I think something like 18 players voted in terms of actually 18 players got a vote. So that just shows you again, there's a bit of a spread of how people perceive, you know, what the contribution was. So I was really pleased with that. So in third position with is Gussie Lingham. Well done, Gus. Good man. In second position, or second lot of votes, was Cam Wilson. Cam, does that mean you're in the leadership group next year? No? Fair enough. But the winner of the Players MVP Award for 2021 is our captain, Joe Hansen. By the way, Craig, do you feel overdressed up here?
Yeah, well, I'd like to thank the boys again, yeah, for voting me. It's been a good year. From where we've come from and to where we are now is obviously huge accreditation to Jermo and what we want to do. It's good to see all the boys sign on for next year. So we've got a lot of work to go, but where we want to get to is we're on the right path and see all the boys coming back. Like, we've got my brother, with Robbo and Jylane, all them. Where we're going is an exciting time. So everyone get on board. Where we're going is going to be huge, so let's go.
Well done, Joey. All right, the next award, I think, might be... We'll go straight to the third best and fairest. Would that be fair to say? Hey. Okay. So, no, that's okay. So our third best and fairest, we all know who finished third, but this guy, as I said, I spoke to him the other night because he'd just come off a four-week honeymoon with Jess. So I had a chat with him the other night. He actually said to me he was always thrown in the ruck. He was playing here, there and everywhere, and he said it was the first time he's actually probably settled in a position and certainly in the midfield, and I thought that each week he got better. And we spoke about areas he certainly knows he needs to keep working on, but that's the beauty of him. He's a professional and he knows what he needs to do, and he's really excited about next year. I think it's the first time in a long while that he signed up before Christmas. I think this time last year he was the phantom, he was a ghost. We couldn't find him, but anyway. But it's great to see that this year took a real step forward in terms of playing in the midfield, and I'm really excited about what you'll be able to do next year. So there's Jared's stats from the season. So our third best and fairest winner is Jared Lane. The big fella's had enough. He's got a big week on the header this week, so he says. Okay, our runner-up. And it was really close. Obviously, just pipped Jared by a vote. But I think I'm really pleased with how the voting went, because I reckon it's mirrored exactly the commitment levels and the effort and the impact that the players have had this year. And our runner-up, the Jim Sandrell medal this year, goes to a guy who was part of the coaching staff, so obviously I had a little bit more to do with him in terms of off-field, you know, being able to talk with him, you know, match committees and stuff like that, and also he's worked around stoppage structures. I was really pleased with how him and Dancers certainly went with their work as assistant coaches, certainly in the midfield with our stoppage work. And as I said, he's had a super year, got a lot of hard, got his own business, got two young kids, has to travel from Albury, so a lot of commitment, but I still think that it was a worthy runner-up this year, and that goes to Damien Wilson.
Okay, Damien's just going to say a few words. We'll just point the...
Obviously, yeah, extremely humbled and grateful, and congratulations to the guys that are already up here and the guys that are within our playing group. Congratulations to the netballers that have had a tremendous season, and unfortunately it didn't get to go ahead and get that ultimate success. But, yeah, it's been terrific, and like Pete spoke about, it is a fair effort from the Albury group, netball, football, whatever it is, it is that 40 sort of minutes, and there's X amount of clubs closer, and for the group to commit and keep coming back, it's I take my hat off to each and every one of everyone. So, and obviously it hasn't been announced yet, but I just want to take the chance to congratulate Cameron on a super year, and he's been terrific, and about time he got one better. So congratulations, thank you.
Well done, Damien. And then, of course, the culmination of our senior awards is the Jim Sandrell Medal. For those, I don't think there'd be anyone in this room who doesn't know too much about Jim Sandrell. He's a legend of a footballer. He's had a decorated career with Melbourne Football Club in the AFL. He came back to Corowa, a best and fairest player. He's in our Team of the Century, Ovens and Murray Hall of Fame. Still proudly donning the Melbourne gear up here at the moment. We're so grateful, Jim, to have you here to present the medal for the best and fairest. And Jermo's just going to announce that, and we'll make that presentation right now.
Righto, thanks, Craig. Yep, I think right from the start of the year when I first... to be honest, I was up in Cairns, and I was working up there, and I'd accepted the job. And anyway, Craig sent this dossier to me and phone numbers, and he said, can you start giving all these guys a ring? And couldn't get a hold of Jared. Joey was great. Gussie Lingham, can I ring anyone else? What can I do for you? Anyway, and I got a hold of young Cam, and I said, Cam, Peter German here. He goes, oh, yeah. I said, mate, I heard, you're ready for a big year this year. He goes, I haven't really thought about footy, to be honest. And I'm thinking, okay. So anyway, trying to get blood out of a stone and, you know, talking a bit about it. And I said, well, you know, do you think that you're going to be on board this year? He goes, yeah, I think I will, you know, but I'm not sure. I just work, you know, just family. And I said, no worries, mate. Well, when I get up there, let's have a chat and we'll catch up. And anyway, so I'm thinking, geez, I don't even know this guy's going to play, you know. But anyway, from day one, was there, front and centre, didn't say anything like he usually doesn't say, but done all his talking with his training, his work ethic, his preparation. I could see right from the start, I said, this kid wants to try and take his football to another level. And that's what you need. As a senior coach, you always need someone who's trying to set the bar higher. And I believe Cameron's done that this year, and I think that that's only going to keep increasing because he's only 20 years of age now. But by geez, even right from that start of the year, I just almost knew straight away, I said, something's really going to have to go wrong for this guy not to be in our top three players. And he's had a super year. If you have a look at his stats, the stats will come up. He was pretty much either number one, two or three in just about every area. Really committed. I'd like to see you kick probably about 10, 12, 15 goals next year, Cameron, but that's one area we can work on. But in saying that, I just think everyone in this room knows that the 2021 Jim Sandrell medalist is a well-deserved winner, and that's Cameron Wilson.
So, Jim, if you make your way to the lectern, I'm sure you'd like to congratulate Cameron in your own way.
Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, I'm presenting the medal for the best and fairest player of the Corowa-Rutherglen Football Club. And it's fortunate we got two brothers that come first and second this year, so how was that? And... I don't know which one was kicking the ball to the other bloke, but anyway, I call them number five and number eight. I get them mixed up a bit, but anyway, I must congratulate the best and fairest winner, and every player that plays with a club, they all love to win the best and fairest of the club. Anyway, so it's come off the number five who's won this year. You number five?
Yeah.
anyway, so that's a great effort. And he's got a lot of football in him yet, mind you. And so is his brother. And they're ball goers and they want to get a kick. And while you've got the ball, no one else has. So anyway, they'll go a long way. I just wish to congratulate him again, number five, for winning, and congratulate number two for coming second. And he's anyway, it's a wonderful effort. They come from a league across at Rutherglen, not quite as good as Owens or Murray, and they picked up the game pretty quick here, and they showed us how they can play football. Congratulations once again. I'll put this medal on.
Yeah, like Jeremy said, we'll see how this goes. Not sure where to start. Like Jim, it's a massive honour to win this award. Jim Sandrell, family's a big part of footy. Family's a big part of sport. I guess that's the reason why you play. I've been lucky enough to play with Damien, who's a very deserving winner of runner-up finally for once. But nah, thank you. Yeah, it's been an honour to play for you all my life. Been an honour to play with family all around. You got the Chandlers, you got the Longmires, you got the Sandrills. The list goes on. The list just keeps going here. So it's been very, very humbling to win this and to play at a club that family is so strong. I got my pop out there. Mum and Dad are at home. Everyone, Claire, my sister who's watching, thank you for all your support. To my partner, Rebecca, thanks for putting up with me. There's been a few nights that, Jermo's really ticked me off and, I don't know, running's, I don't like to let it go out at training, but yeah, some nights I'm not very happy, but anyways, but nah, thank you. Thank you to Jermo. Look, I've had some coaches. I've been lucky enough to play at some, as Easy and that would know, like some highly regarded coaches around, and you're definitely up there with the best coach I've had. There's not many people that, you look up to so much, but where you've come from, where you're going, and to leave your family for so long, I guess that's a massive sacrifice, and to show what you're really committed to. So I guess that's one thing, definitely. To the sponsors, to Netballer Girls, well done on your year. Bad luck for finishing the way it did. I'm sure, you would have went to the end. It's very good to see some success. Not sure where to go. The sponsors, the farmers, everyone who makes the club run, the harvest. Everyone, the Longmires, the Chalkies, the harvest goes on. Just the money that's donated to clubs, you don't really get seen. It doesn't get seen enough. So thank you to everyone. The trainers, everyone, it's week in, week out, strapping. There's a lot of boys that need strapping, and I tell you what, some boys, I don't know how they run around with strapping on. I don't even reckon I could move in it, but. Yes, thank you for putting up with that. To the boys, it's been an awesome effort. It's only one step. There's another big step to go, so we just keep going. But to the recruiters and that, to the boys in Melbourne, it's massive to recruit boys from Melbourne with the footy knowledge that you have, but just the way Tommy Goodwin and Charlie and Marksy go about it, like Tommy's in there after a game. Normally some players dash off back to Melbourne, but Tommy's in there after a game shoving a VB down everyone's throat. So it's the character that those boys have. So thank you very much and very humbling. Thank you.
Thanks, Cameron. Put your hands together for a worthy winner of the Jim Sandrell Medal, Cameron Wilson. Okay. Just a couple of things before we go. Obviously, you know, our award winners here tonight have all come through our club. We've got an exciting group of young players, but on Sunday, this Sunday, down at the John Ford Oval, our junior football club will be having its presentation from around noon. So we wish those guys all the best, and if anyone can make it down there and offer their support, Sunday down at the John Ford Oval for the junior presentation day. The other thing is, a night like this, which has been such a great success, and I know we've all enjoyed getting back together with each other and socialising, because every time we went to put something on this year, it got cancelled or pulled from under us. This has been a fantastic night, but it doesn't just happen itself. And I'd like to make a special thanks to Rowena Black, who's helped really put this night together and make it a success for everyone. So, Rowena, thank you very much for your strong efforts. You know, she was right under the pump today, but came through, and she's managed to coordinate all the technology as well as the awards and put the function on all together. The little bit of a surprise that Jermo mentioned is the RSL have been kind enough to say that if we finished on time and everyone was feeling good, we could get up and have a bit of a dance. So that's something that we didn't think would happen. The light at the end of the tunnel is just about here. So let's let our hair down. We want to see you all back in 2022. Thank you for your attendance tonight, and have a great weekend ahead of you. Thank you.